University of Oklahoma football is on the air. Every play, every exciting minute of this week's game. OU football is brought to you by your metro area Pontiac dealers. We build excitement. And by Allied Oklahoma Bank, the bank with Get Up and Grow. By Grider's Discount Food Stores, Grider's Saves. And by KGMC-TV, Channel 34, the winner. And now, here's Chris Lincoln and Robbie Robertson.
From Owen Field in Norman, it's University of Oklahoma football. The Oklahoma Sooners play host to the Iowa State Cyclones in Big 8 Conference football. Hi, everybody. I'm Robbie Robertson. Along with Bob Barry, Jr., Chris Lincoln is on special assignment this week. He'll be back with us next week. It's a pleasure to be working with Bob, Jr., and I guarantee you both ball clubs come in here 2-0. This turns out to be an important ball game, Bob.
Well, it sure does, Robbie. It's just a little bit chilly down here, and it's a little surprising that Iowa State comes in here having won 3 ball games this year. We expected them to be at the bottom of the Big 8. As it turns out, they're tied with Oklahoma and Nebraska for first place, so it is a big game indeed.
The Iowa State Cyclones will probably put it up about 50 today. Don't have much of a rushing game. They certainly like to throw the football, and this turns out to be an important game for OU offensively, Bob.
That's right, Robbie. There have been a few changes since Oklahoma is now playing AD after Dupree. In fact, they put Spencer Tillman back at tailback, who will line up there today in a starting role, we feel, and Alvin Ross will probably line up at fullback, and then there will be a change or two on the line. Jeff Pickett, the big freshman from Texarkana, Texas, will be at an offensive guard in place of Tim Randolph and Eric Pope, who are out with injuries.
The Oklahoma Sooners looking for some consistency on offense. Iowa State hoping to pull the upset today. It's Dad's Day in Norman. This is the 56th meeting between Oklahoma and Iowa State. The Sooners have not lost to an Iowa State team in 21 years. We'll be back with the opening kickoff in just a minute. A cloudy day. We've had a little drizzle here. We've had so much rain in the Oklahoma City area the past 2.5 days. Had a little bit of rain this morning, nothing serious. The field does not seem to be in too bad a shape. Here comes Tim Lasher, and we're underway. Line drive kick into the end zone. Richard Hansen takes it and downs it in the end zone, and the Iowa State Cyclones will go on offense from their own 20-yard line.
Robbie, now we get to see David Archer in the Iowa State passing game, which comes into this ball game ranked second in the Big 8, averaging about 238 yards a game. David Archer, number 18 for Iowa State, has thrown for over 200 yards and 2 touchdowns in each of the last 5 games. He will throw to a bevy of people, including his running backs coming out of the backfield.
Iowa State will be in so many offensive sets today, it'll really be something. Archer, the quarterback. Jason Jacobs is the lone setback. Jacobs on the run to the left, and the Oklahoma defense is there to stop him after a gain of just a couple. Jackie Shipp and Kevin Murphy on the stop as you take a look at the Iowa State offense.
David Archer will be the quarterback. Tommy Davis, the team's leading rusher, and Jason Jacobs in the backfield, the numbers 1 and 2 rushers. Tracy Henderson, the leading receiver in the Big 8, is at flanker, and Robbie Miner is the wingback. Dave Schmolt, the tight end. Ben Musgrave and Reimers, the left tackle and left guard. The center is Myers. Nelson and Martin round out that offensive line for Iowa State.
Split backs. Curtis Levingston goes in motion. Throw to Levingston. He is close to the first down as he is tackled at about the 30 by Keith Stanberry.
Oklahoma has a defensive change. Sonny Brown is starting back there for the Sooners, and Scott Case has moved over to a cornerback, so Sonny Brown is starting at a free safety. And you can see the defensive lineup, Goodlow and Bryan, along with Casillas, Slater, and Murphy. That's an outstanding defense, one that leads the Big 8 Conference in rushing defense, passing defense, and total defense. Benson, Shipp, Case, Drain, Stanberry, and Brown round out the Sooner defense. Been a long time, Robbie, since Oklahoma's defense has dominated the league like it has this season.
Big 8 Conference leaders in total defense as Archer brings the Cyclones to the line of scrimmage. First down from the 30. Split backs. The handoff is to Tommy Davis, the halfback, second leading rusher on the team. Picks up a couple. Oklahoma leads the Big 8 Conference in rushing defense. They are 10th in the nation, giving up about 92 yards a game on the ground. Davis picks up a little more than three. Call it second and seven from the Iowa State 33-yard line. Robbie Miner comes wide left. Archer throws to Miner, who drops the ball. Keith Stanberry there to greet Robbie Miner, a 6 foot, 174-pound freshman from Hazelwood, Missouri.
Robbie Miner had the pass in his hands, but he just couldn't hold on. However, Keith Stanberry was waiting for the tackle and didn't have to make one since the pass was incomplete. Now, Iowa State, rushing-wise, Robbie and I were talking before the game, on the season, 434 yards rushing compared to 432 yards in penalties against Oklahoma's football team. Unbelievable.
Not much to brag about in running the football. They live and die by the pass, third and seven for the Cyclones. David Archer, the quarterback, split backs. Archer straight back. Looking for room over the middle. He's got the tight end, Dave Smolt, big game. Inside the Sooner 45-yard line, a 24-yard pickup. Archer to Dave Smolt.
One of the things Oklahoma's defensive line will have to do is get to David Archer. If you let him roll out that pocket and get away as he did that time, he can find Smolt, and Iowa State loves to throw in that 15 to 17-yard range. That is what they will try to do to the Sooners, get in the intermediate zones as they did there in a pickup of 24 there in Oklahoma territory.
A couple of first downs for the Cyclones. Split back offensive set from the Oklahoma 44-yard line. The hand is to Tommy Davis up the middle for just a couple. Davis was the Iowa State leading rusher last year, fifth in the Big 8 Conference. Davis will come out of the ball game now. Pickup of just three. Second and seven for Iowa State from the Sooner 41. Oklahoma leads this series, 49 victories, four losses and two ties, as Archer brings the Cyclones to the line of scrimmage, second and seven from the 41. The lone back, Jason Jacobs. Quickly out to the left flat to the flanker, Tracy Henderson, who gets inside the Sooner 35-yard line, a pickup of six.
Tracy Henderson is the one the Sooners are most concerned about. He leads the Big 8 with 35 receptions already, and he was expected just to be a second line, maybe a fill-in player for Iowa State this year, but with the fact that Michael Wade has not gotten off to a good start and not even caught a pass for the Cyclones, Tracy Henderson has come on to not only play well but lead the conference, so he is a dangerous threat on the flank for Iowa State.
Third and one from the Sooner 34. Jacobs up the middle. Looks like he's got the first down. Iowa State with a record of 3-3. They're on a roll. They've won their last two ball games, both of them Big 8 Conference victories, as the officials call timeout to bring the chains across the field. 11:37 to go, first quarter.
Well, if you notice that time, Iowa State tried to quick pitch the Sooners just a little bit. They ran up to the line in a hurry and got off the play in time. There is a timeout on the field, 11:37 to go in the first quarter. No score between Oklahoma and Iowa State. This is Oklahoma football.
Junior along here as the Iowa State Cyclones have a first down at the Sooner 34. Archer hands to Tommy Davis. He's got running room off the right side inside the Sooner 25-yard line. An 11-yard pickup for little Tommy Davis, 5'8", a 190-pound junior from East St. Louis, Illinois.
Well, Davis just ran over the right side. Last season, he was Iowa State's leading rusher with almost 900 yards. And just to show you how Jim Kreiner has changed up this offense, he's still the leading rusher coming into this game, but with about 700 yards less. So Iowa State more of a passing team that time, Davis for 11.
Another first down for the Cyclones. Archer rolls left. And he's got his flanker, Tracy Henderson, inside the Sooner 15-yard line. And this Iowa State offense has been pretty impressive thus far.
I would sure say so. In fact, I think unofficially, we have David Archer is completing four or five passes for 48 yards here on this opening drive. So he came into the game hitting 56% of his passes, and we have a penalty flag, though, as you see. The holding call will move things back and nullify that play, but it has to worry the OU coaching staff that Dave Archer is completing and having the time to complete the passes.
Well, even though they don't have a running game to speak of, as we take a look at today's officials, Harold Rose, the referee, Frank Gaines, the umpire, Tom Ellers, John Kleinsmith, William Spixma, as we listen to the call, as we watch the call. So that moves the Iowa State Cyclones back to the 28-yard line. It'll now be first and 15 from the Sooner 28. This drive started from the Iowa State 20. Anytime a team can throw the ball like Iowa State, the defense has got some concerns. First and 15 from the Oklahoma 28. Jason Jacobs, the lone setback, quickly out into the flat to Henderson, who gets out of bounds at about the 19-yard line. Kevin Murphy and Dwight Drain ran him out of bounds. Pickup of 9.
Nothing fancy about it. Iowa State is running a lone setback on 3/4 of these plays. Usually Jason Jacobs standing back there as the only setback behind Archer, and they've got flanks or wideouts to either side. So they're just throwing it to pop out to the side as quickly as possible, and the receivers are doing the rest, picking up 8, 9, 10 yards a chunk.
The ball's inside the 20. Second and 6 for the Cyclones at the 19. Jacobs the setback. And the pitch to Jacobs around the left end. Doesn't get much. Jackie Shipp there on the tackle for the Sooners. 10:29 to go in the first quarter. Danny Gant enters the lineup for Iowa State. Dave Smolt, tight end, comes out. Archer is 4 of 5 through the air for 46 yards in this drive. Robbie Miner. This split wide right. Another formation for Iowa State, and they throw to the right side, and Miner can't hold on to that one either. Scott Case on the hit.
Both plays have been similar to Robbie Miner, one time to the left and this time to the right. Both times the ball has been on the mark, but Robbie Miner has not been able to hold on. So the holding penalty, culminated by that missed catch by Robbie Miner, has hurt Iowa State, and they'll bring on back road here to attempt what looks to be like a 34-yard field goal.
He hasn't missed this year. Mark Backroat, a sophomore from Rockford, Illinois, 6 of 6 in the field goal department this year. He will kick this from the 24. It'll be a 34-yard attempt. It's up, and it's good, and Iowa State is on the scoreboard on a 34-yard field goal by Mark Backroat with 9:55 to go in the first quarter. It's Iowa State 3, Oklahoma nothing. This is Oklahoma football. On offense, as Iowa State took the first possession at their own 20-yard line, drove down close enough to give Mark Backroad an opportunity for a 34-yard field goal. He nailed it, and Iowa State's on the board, leading Oklahoma 3-0.
We thought for a time Iowa State might be hurting without Alex Gifford, a great kicker that played for them years ago, and you see this time they went 12 plays, 80 yards, 5 minutes off the clock, and Backroad, who came in here as an unexpected star for Iowa State this year. He won the Kansas game earlier, and he boots another field goal, this one from 34 yards out. He's 7 of 7 on the year, and I think the Cyclones have surprised this sellout crowd in Norman today, and it's now 3-0, Cyclones leading.
Well, they seem to be getting better and better every week. They are coached by first-year coach Jim Kreiner, a no-nonsense type coach. We'll talk more about him later today as Backroad tees it up. Buster Rhymes and Derek Shepard are deep for the Oklahoma Sooners. Rhymes averaging better than 23 yards a kickoff return. Shepard's just returned one kickoff this year for 15 yards, that against Oklahoma State. Backroad boots it into a wind. It'll go to Rhymes at the 9-yard line. Back to the 20. He's got some running room at the 35. Across the 45, close to midfield, Buster Rhymes. A 39-yard kickoff return to give the Oklahoma Sooners great field position at their own 47-yard line.
Well, Oklahoma came into this game leading the league in kickoff returns at almost 22 yards, and that time Buster Rhymes saw the wedge and just went straight up the middle, way to follow his blocking, and Rhymes took advantage of it with that great speed and those loping strides, and he went 39 yards, and Oklahoma starts out at their own 48. We want to mention Earl Johnson is the starting tailback, Alvin Ross, the fullback.
Danny Bradley, the quarterback. Sewell is in motion. The hand is to Earl Johnson off the left side across midfield into Iowa State territory. Chris Washington on the tackle for Iowa State, a pickup of 5 for the Dallas freshman Earl Johnson. Earl Johnson and Spencer Tillman will be sharing the duties at tailback. OU head coach Barry Switzer has said that they are going to give the ball to the tailback 30 or 40 times a ball game.
And Chris Washington was in on the tackle for Iowa State. You'll hear a lot from number 54, Chris Washington, for Iowa State today. He led the Big 8 in solo tackles a year ago. He is the headhunter on the Cyclones defense.
Sewell in motion again to the near side of the field. Again, the pitch to Johnson, and he is hit immediately as he picks up just a yard or so. Linebacker Doug Fisher on the tackle for Iowa State. They play a 3-4 alignment. At least that's what they call it. It looks more like a 5-2. They do have three down linemen, but their two outside linebackers are real close to the line of scrimmage. They feel like they have more talent at the linebacking position than any place else on the defensive side of the football, so those are the people they try and get involved in the play. Johnson picked up just a couple of, they've marked it no gain. It's third and five, and now we've got timeout Oklahoma. 8:37 to go in the first quarter. Iowa State leads Oklahoma 3-0. This is Oklahoma football. 37 to go in the first quarter. The Oklahoma Sooners trailing Iowa State 3-0. This is the first time Oklahoma's had the football. Iowa State used more than 5 minutes on the clock on their first possession. Got a 34-yard field goal out of it to lead the Oklahoma Sooners 3-0. This is the 56th meeting. Oklahoma has gone 21 straight games without a loss to Iowa State. The last Iowa State victory was in 1961 in Norman. They did play to a 7-7 tie here 2 years ago. Last year in Ames, the Sooners were the winners 13-3. Danny Bradley breaks the huddle. Sooners are in the eye. Alvin Ross at fullback. Earl Johnson at tailback. Sewell comes in motion. Buster Rhymes split wide right. Bradley on the option. The pitch to Johnson around the right side. Got some room at the 30, 20, 15, 10, 5 out of bounds at about the 2-yard line. We'll see where they mark it. At the 2-yard line, a great run by Earl Johnson. 50 yards.
The player that made that play was Steve Sewell, a tremendous blocker coming out of the option on the right side. And we're looking down into the corner. We'll watch it on replay. Watch Sewell, number 13, as I think he's the one that throws the block that gets Earl Johnson outside. Bottom of your screen, Sewell goes out and gets the defensive back, and that sparks the option. This looks like Oklahoma of old. Johnson then does the rest, a great stiff arm there, and he tight ropes the boundary 50 yards, and he's knocked out of bounds at the Iowa State 2-yard line. The Sooners knocking at the door with 8:26 to go in the opening period.
And Earl Johnson is hurt. He is limping off the field. Spencer Tillman has now come in at the tailback spot. Kevin Williams ran Johnson out of bounds. Williams from his right cornerback spot. Earl Johnson, the freshman from Dallas, injured on the 50-yard run. Johnson was over the 100-yard mark last week against Oklahoma State, had 105 yards on 25 carries. Named the 82 Texas All-Star Game Most Valuable Player.
Has a pretty healthy day going so far, Robbie. 3 carries for 55 yards, but we hope at this point that he's not shaken up too terribly, because Oklahoma needs both Earl Johnson and Spencer Tillman there at the tailback situation.
Take a look at the Oklahoma huddle. 8:25 to go in the first quarter. Sooners break the huddle. Alvin Ross at fullback. Spencer Tillman at tailback. Two tight ends, Fontenette and Berryhill. The hand is to Spencer Tillman, who dives into the end zone. Touchdown. Spencer Tillman, the first time he carries the ball, dives about 5 yards into the end zone. Touchdown for the Oklahoma Sooners and touchdown for Spencer Tillman.
That has to be fun to come into the game and grab the football and grab the glory on your first carry. A dive by Spencer Tillman looked like Billy Sims of old. The Sooners lead at 6-3. Tim Lasher to try the extra point.
Tim Lasher's hit on 10 of 11 this year. He's got it up and it's good. 8:23 to go in the first quarter. The Oklahoma Sooners have come right back, set up on a great kickoff return by Buster Rhymes. Take another look at Spencer Tillman.
Looks like Greg Louganis, the Olympic diver here. Nice swan effort over the top of everybody. He almost went untouched. In fact, I think he did. Great dive by Spencer Tillman. Oklahoma has regained the lead 7-3 here with 8:23 to go in the opening quarter. Oklahoma got the great kickoff return by Rimes, 39 yards, and then a 50-yard run by Earl Johnson. So that's doing it in a hurry, and that's what Jim Kreiner and his staff are worried about. They have had problems defending the rush this year, and they certainly had a problem, even though the turf is a little wet down there. Johnson was able to get outside easily thanks to a good block by Steve Sewell. Robbie, Iowa State will be in for a long, long afternoon if Oklahoma is able to get the corner. That's a no-no against the Sooners.
Well, Oklahoma, as you saw OU head coach Barry Switzer on the sideline there, really is concerned about developing some consistency. As you take a look at Richard Hansen, who is deep for Iowa State in the end zone, wants some consistency on the offense. Oklahoma just has not taken the ball and driven 70, 80 yards. Just take a look at that scoring drive, 52 yards in four plays. Just took a minute and a half. But I know that drive will give the Oklahoma offense some confidence. As Leisher boots it deep, Hansen won't return this one. It goes out of the end zone. So Iowa State will start from their own 20. That's where they started on their first possession. Ended up with a field goal as David Archer hit four of six passes for 46 yards in the first drive. And Iowa State will start again from their own 20, 8:23 to go in the first quarter. Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State, 7-3.
Cyclones on that first drive, I think, were two of three on third down conversions. And if Robbie Miner could have held on to the football, they might have gone in for the 6 points. So they had to be comfortable with the way they were able to move the ball the first time they had it.
Tracy Henderson has split far left as Jacobs goes in motion. Archer straight back. We'll see that all day. Pass intended for Jacobs. Goes incomplete. Jason Jacobs is the fullback. 6'1", 229-pound senior from Chicago, Illinois. He is the second leading receiver on the Iowa State Ball Club. They will throw to everybody.
They sure will. As many as maybe nine players today. In all fairness to Jacobs on that particular play, probably the poorest throw by Archer on the afternoon, a little behind. It could have been something slipping on the turf, but he's missed his last two passes now.
Second and 10, Jacobs and Davis, the split backs. Attempted draw play to Jacobs, finds some running room, broke some tackles, and gets up to the 25-yard line. White Drain and Sonny Brown from the OU secondary came up to make the tackle. Good pickup for Jason Jacobs. Should have had that play stopped in the backfield.
Well, let's watch it and see. It looked like the Sooners had it read. Tony Casillas and Kevin Murphy were in there, but Jacobs weighs 230 pounds, and he runs low to the ground, and he was able to break out of it there and carry Sonny Brown for a yard or two, and Iowa State's in business.
Sonny Brown getting a start today because of the injury to Jim Rockford. Third and five for Iowa State from the Sooner 25. Archer throws, and he's got his man, Robbie Miner. Across the 30, it'll be a first down for Iowa State. 7-yard pickup.
There's something, aren't they? They don't make any bones about it. They send everybody in motion. They put everybody as wide out as possible. They just flat tell everyone in the world they're going to throw the football. They're doing it well now. Iowa State now 5 of 7, I believe, on the day for about 53 yards. So Archer off to a good start.
First and 10 for Iowa State from the Sooner 33-yard line. Oklahoma in front, 7-3. Archer straight back. Flag goes down. Pass is complete. Kevin Murphy on the stop will have to read the flag.
Tommy Davis looking for his helmet there. Kevin Murphy, a pretty good stick. Anytime the flag is thrown in there, I believe is in the offensive line, we'll probably have a holding against Iowa State, but let's see what the official calls.
The Sooners are the ones that have been plagued by penalties this year, but Iowa State's been flagged twice today. A couple of holding calls, so that'll move Iowa State back as they would have had the first down on the completion to Tommy Davis, but the holding call will move Iowa State back.
Cyclones offensive line is big. They average probably about 266 pounds, but they have been a little brittle this year. They've suffered some injuries, as you see David Archer, the fine quarterback, but their offensive line, Reimers and Musgrave, their two returning starters, a couple of injuries. They've been a little bit shaky this season, and they've had problems in their opening ball games, but in the last two Big Eight contests, they've held up well because Archer has thrown for about 500 yards in the last two games.
This is the first time in about a month that Iowa State's been away from home. They played five of their first six ball games at home. The penalty's been marked off. It's first and 20 for Iowa State from their own 23-yard line. Here comes Jacobs in motion, and he makes the reception. Then he just run out of bound by a host of Sooners. Stanberry and Case there to ride Jacobs out of bounds. Be a short pickup, about 6 yards. David Archer, 6'2", 200-pound senior from Soda Springs, Idaho. He's a junior college transfer. You should take another look at it.
Archer just throws straight sideline for Jacobs, who went in motion on the play. And he was out there for a short 6 or 7 yard gain. But you have to remember, Oklahoma has great lateral pursuit and good team speed on defense. They were able to keep it to a short 6 or 7 yard play. But those plays add up, and that's what Iowa State's been moving on here in the first period.
Robbie Miner split wide right. Danny Gant split to the left. Archer straight back. Everybody out. Under pressure. Down he goes. Tony Casillas. That's what Oklahoma needs to do, put the pressure on the quarterback, a loss of 5. And for Oklahoma this year, that is their 23rd quarterback sack.
Let's watch big number 92 there at the bottom of your screen. Tony Casillas, his third quarterback sack this year. Looked like Archer had some time, but credit the defensive secondary, was there for the coverage, and Casillas makes the stop.
Tony Casillas beat the block of the Iowa State center, Chuck Myers. Iowa State not very big up front on the offensive line. Sooners have the advantage there. Third and 19 for Iowa State. Archer throws in and out of the hands of Robbie Miner. He is really having a terrible day. Scott Case on the coverage.
Well, Miner's been there 3 times, and so has the football. And unfortunately, he's come up 0-3. Watch it again. David Archer back to pass. He'll look for number 87 right side. He got into that middle zone for Oklahoma. Scott Case was there, though, and might have intimidated Miner. Hit him right there in the hands, but Scott Case comes up and says, "How do you do? Glad you didn't catch that."
Kelly Goodburn punched the ball away for Iowa State. And up man for Oklahoma, Sonny Brown, makes the reception, a 25-yard punt. So Oklahoma is going to have great field position. 6:05 to go, first quarter. Oklahoma 7, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. 49, Sewell in motion. The hand is to Spencer Tillman off the left side. Picks up some good yardage. Dwayne Gilliard on the tackle for Iowa State. Pick up a 5 for Spencer Tillman in the ball game because of the injury to Earl Johnson.
Let's watch number 34 from Tulsa Edison. Lining up at tailback now, probably his better position because of his elusive running nature. Tillman over there at left side for about 5 yards. He was Oklahoma's leading rusher coming into today with 458 yards, averaging about 5 yards a carry.
Second and 5 for Oklahoma from the Iowa State 44. The hand to Tillman again, keeps his balance across the 40, down inside the Iowa State 40-yard line as George Walker came up and made the tackle. Pretty good block by Brent Burks off that left side to enable Tillman to get close to the first down marker. It looks like it is a first down for Oklahoma.
Watch Spencer run into Jeff Pickett here, the freshman, getting the start today. He uses the helmet a little bit as a battering ram. Picks up good yardage, good pursuit by Iowa State, but not until Tillman had gained 5-6 yards. Nice run.
Pickett needs to get that uniform dirty down there. Be on the turf, although it won't get too dirty on artificial turf, will it?
A little wet today, maybe.
Yeah, we've got an injured Iowa State player being escorted off the field. Cornerback Joe Jackson, a junior college transfer, being escorted off the field. Take a look at Jim Kreiner on the Iowa State sideline. In his first year at Iowa State, it's first and 10 for the Sooners from the Iowa State 38. Sewell in motion. Handoff up the middle to Spencer Tillman for just a couple.
That hole closed rapidly over the right side. Pickett and Sidney Dodd over there. It was open for a little while, and Spencer jumped in there, and that's what Coach Switzer hopes to see more of this season, is Spencer Tillman's quickness off the football. He's a very good starter, and he jumps in there 2 or 3 yards very quickly now. Has 14 yards on the day in 4 carries.
Iowa State is 6th in the Big 8 Conference in total defense. They give up about 377 yards a game, give up 170 a game on the ground. 6th in the Big 8 against the rush. As Sewell comes in motion again, the handoff, Bradley keeps it on the corner. Got some running room, but then an excellent defensive play by the strong safety, Alvin Baker, a senior, cuts Bradley down, and Danny Bradley picks up 7, but he could have run some more if Alvin Baker hadn't gotten a hand on him and tripped him up.
Looked like Danny was also looking for Buster Rhymes maybe to pitch there right before he went down. Steve Sewell, another great block to spring Danny Bradley to the outside, and that time Sewell knocked down Chris Washington of Iowa State. You see Coach Barry Switzer, what a record he has at home against Big 8 opposition. Coach Switzer coming into today has a record of 32-2-2, 31-2-2.
Spencer Tillman's got some running room off the left side. Just needed less than a yard for the first down. Picks up seven. Oklahoma has not made a mistake today thus far as they get another first down as the ball is inside the Iowa State 25-yard line. They mark it at the 23. First and 10 for the Sooners at the Iowa State 23. 3:50 to go in the first quarter. Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State 7-3. Buster Rhymes split wide left. Sewell in motion to the left. The handoff is to Alvin Ross up the middle from the fullback spot inside the 15 down to the 10. Alvin Ross has not had an opportunity to carry the ball very much this year, but he picks up 13 right there.
Alvin came into the game having rushed for just 31 yards on the season, but look at Ross do some nice cutting back there, and the Illinois native gets it down inside with some tough running, and Oklahoma is now at the just outside of the 10-yard line in great shape. Field position has been a key in this game. Their first drive, 52 yards, and this one they started at the Iowa State 49.
Credit Paul Parker with a good block on that last play as Sewell goes in motion. The pitch to Spencer Tillman, left side stacked up. He's not going to go anywhere. Fumbles the football, and Iowa State's got it. Oh, the turnover bugaboo again. Spencer Tillman fumbled again. Last week, Dwayne Gilliard on the recovery for Iowa State.
Let's see what happened. Danny Bradley gets the pitch to Tillman. It looked like Paul Parker was having a few problems, and Alvin Ross trying to get that block down on the left side, but Spencer was just stood straight up. A good defensive play. George Walker there of Iowa State, as he fights off the two blocks and causes the fumble. You see Walker using a lot of his hands there. And finally, the recovery made by Gilliard. So Iowa State dodges a bullet, and they'll start deep in their own territory at the 9-yard line.
That's the 18th fumble that Oklahoma has lost just this year. Iowa State starts from their own 9-yard line. Archer hands off to Jason Jacobs. No place to go. So Oklahoma comes up with a turnover as Spencer Tillman fumbles. Iowa State starts their third possession from their own 9-yard line. They get nothing on first down.
Even though Tillman lost the football, Robbie, it's safe to say that Oklahoma has really picked up a lot of confidence here in the first quarter. You see Dwayne Gilliard, 51. He's the one that recovered the fumble. A little defensive meeting over there. Gilliard has missed a few games because of injury, but the Oklahoma offense is still a lot of more confidence than they had last week.
Second and 9 for Iowa State from the 10. The pitch to Jacobs, trying to get around the right side. Got some room. Gets out of bounds at about the 17-yard line is where they'll mark it. Scott Case runs him out of bounds. Pickup of 7. Jim Rockford, the starting cornerback, unable to go today because of injury, so Scott Case starts at cornerback. Sonny Brown starts at free safety. Brown, just a freshman from Alice, Texas. 2:26 to go here in the first quarter. Third down and 2 at the Iowa State 17-yard line. Jason Jacobs, the lone setback, moves over a couple of steps to the right. Archer quickly throws, and Scott Case is right there. A great defensive play as the pass went to the flanker, Tracy Henderson, but Scott Case had that play sniffed out and stopped it for a loss, and now Iowa State quickly gets their punting team on the field. As you take another look at Archer, the pass to Henderson, but Case is right there, and Kelly Goodburn is a high spiral. Oklahoma's going to get good field position as Derek Shepherd takes it, gets across midfield, and then stacked up. Oklahoma again with good field position. A 38-yard punt off the foot of Kelly Goodburn.
Derek Shepherd very slow in getting up for Oklahoma off the football after that 4-yard return. He looks like he has a bit of a difficulty with a leg problem, so we'll have a brief timeout for just a second. It looks like, though, Oklahoma's field position has been fantastic here in the first quarter. Their 52-yard scoring drive to open things, and now they're starting at about the midfield stripe. The last time they had the football, they were at the 49. So we have a minute 53 to go in the first quarter. Oklahoma leads Iowa State 7-3. This is Oklahoma football.
Fullback with got a little problem down there on the field as the officials have a discussion. Oklahoma with a record of 4-2. Sooners have 96 yards total offense thus far today. Iowa State with 102 yards. Iowa State just 32 yards on the ground. All of Oklahoma's offense has come on the ground as Danny Bradley brings the Sooners to the line of scrimmage in the wishbone. The hand is to Alvin Ross, who cuts back, gets close to the Iowa State 40-yard line. Pretty good running by Alvin Ross getting a chance to play this week as he picks up 8 yards. Oklahoma's made some changes in the lineup. And Alvin Ross starts at fullback today. Take another look at
him. I like the way Alvin Ross looks for the cutback. That's the play that has always sprung the fullback in the past at Oklahoma. Look at him cut back against the grain, and that's what earns the fullback big yardage. He runs through George Walker there and powers down, keeps those legs going for an 8-yard pickup. So Alvin Ross has 20 yards rushing today, had only 31 coming into the game for the season.
Had just 2 carries last week against Oklahoma State as the pitch goes to Earl Johnson, and he is hit quickly by defensive tackle Barry Moore, 6'4", 263-pound junior from Quincy, Illinois. Earl Johnson unable to get much there, as it'll now be a 3rd-and-2 situation for Oklahoma at the Iowa State 41-yard line. Marking at the 39, I'm sorry, the Iowa State 39. 3rd-and-1 for Oklahoma. Tight end Fontenette on the right side in the wishbone for Oklahoma. Danny Bradley on the keep, trying to find some place to go. Pitches to Johnson, room at the 20, 15, finally run out of bounds by Kevin Williams for Iowa State. Johnson out of bounds inside the Iowa State 10.
30-yard run for Earl Johnson, so he's had a 50-yarder and a 30-yarder here in the first period alone. Let's watch the play again. I think Danny Bradley makes this play with some excellent faking. And at the very, it's Sewell again on another great block. You see Steve Sewell at 13. Look at Danny. Waits until the last minute to make the pitch. And Johnson really likes this tailback stuff. He's had 80-some-odd yards in the first quarter already. 5 carries for 87 yards.
I'd like that tailback stuff if I had that kind of running room out there. Earl Johnson over the 80-yard mark already, looking for his 3rd 100-yard day of the year as the hand goes to Johnson again, gets inside the 5, and we've got a flag on the play. Chris Washington on the tackle for Iowa State, one of the better Iowa State defenders. 6'4", 227-pound senior from Chicago, Illinois, and here's the penalty. It's going to be holding against Oklahoma. Take another look at it.
See if we can see the hole at the end of the play. Earl Johnson over the left side. Might be Paul Parker there. Looks like he's grabbing on to 91 just a bit. Barry Moore, and that's where the flag came in. This is the stuff that hurts you when you get inside that 4-down territory. Oklahoma set a single game record against Oklahoma State last week with 15 penalties for 145 yards. But we have been talking about penalties this week, and it turns out that the most penalized Oklahoma team ever, 862 yards in a single season, the 1955 national champion. So apparently didn't hinder them too much. And this team is about halfway there as far as yardage total in penalties.
And that was one of the biggest concerns that Coach Switzer had this week, is about developing some consistency with the offense. It seems like whenever they get a drive going, it ends up in a turnover or penalties that impede the drive. So now the ball's been moved back to the Iowa State 19. 1st and 19. From the 19, Sewell goes in motion. They're in the eye. Bradley on the corner. Got some room at the 10. 5. Touchdown, Danny Bradley. Danny Bradley gets his 3rd touchdown of the year. This one on a 19-yard run. Excellent job by Danny Bradley.
Well, watch number 13, Steve Sewell. He's my MVP for the day so far. You'll see Steve Sewell. Well, you can't really see him in our screen. He throws another tremendous block right there at the bottom of your screen. Takes out 2 Iowa State defenders, and Bradley carries the player into the end zone. Another good block by Alvin Ross. So Oklahoma has really been able to get outside.
Lasher with the point after. It's good. Danny Bradley carries Billy McHugh into the end zone, and Oklahoma is on the board again. 10 seconds left in the first quarter. Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State, 14-3. This is Oklahoma football. OU head coach Barry Switzer has never lost to an Iowa State football team. He is 9-0-1 against Iowa State, as Switzer is in his 11th year, looking for his 103rd career victory. And he's got to be pretty pleased thus far with the way that Oklahoma offense has operated, but they have had great field position all day today. Their 3 drives, starting from their own 47, they took it for a touchdown, then they start from the Iowa State 49, fumble it away, and then start from the Iowa State 48 and take it in for another touchdown, and they lead Iowa State 14-3. Richard Hansen is deep for Iowa State. as Tim Lasher gets ready to boot the ball away for the Sooners. It's Dad's Day here in Norman as the football is blown off the kicking tee again. Tim Lasher's dad up from Plano, Texas, Gary Lasher.
Somebody called Tim Uwe Lasher after last week's performance.
Right. Uwe von Lasher. He kicked the biggest field goal of his career, 46-yarder to beat Oklahoma State. Here he goes and kicks it into the end zone. Hansen will take it, and he's going to bring it out at the 5, the 10, the 15. Got some room across the 20 and 25 before he is finally down at about the Iowa State 27-yard line. Jeff Hake, special team player.
Richard Hansen about 8 yards deep in the end zone. Pretty gutsy call here by the sophomore, averaging 19 yards return, but he takes it straight up the boulevard and goes 27 yards on the return. He almost popped it big there, too. Good return by Hansen. Iowa State, their best start of the day, starting at their own 27.
Hansen averaging 19 yards a kickoff return. Davis and Jacobs, the running backs, as Danny Gant goes in motion. Archer hands to Tommy Davis. He's wrapped up quickly by Jackie Shipp and Ricky Bryan. Two outstanding defensive players. Jackie Shipp, all Big Eight. Ricky Bryan, All-American.
One of the few times today Iowa State has started in the true eye, and you see Tommy Davis here as he gets knocked down by Jackie Shipp, which ends the first period of play. So at the end of one quarter, Oklahoma leads Iowa State 14-3. You're watching Oklahoma football.
Pretty good first quarter for the Oklahoma Sooners. Robbie Robertson and Bob Ferry Jr. along with you from Owen Field in Norman, where Oklahoma is out in front of Iowa State 14-3. Iowa State will start the second quarter with a second down and 8 play from their own 29-yard line.
And the people here at the in the north end zone at Owen Field finally getting some action. They didn't have a whole lot to see in that first quarter. Most of the period played in Iowa State territory. All of the Sooner scoring drives, just one of them was just over 50 yards, the other two inside of 50, and that's what you like to see when you're a coach like Barry Switzer on the sideline, that great field position. That's the name of this game.
Another sellout crowd here at Owen Field in Norman, more than 75,000 to watch the Sooners and Cyclones. This is the 55th consecutive sellout for the Oklahoma Sooners. Iowa State returned a bunch of tickets, but the Sooners were able to sell them. The Oklahoma defense has gone to the nickel defense. 5 defensive backs. Tony Rayburn now comes in. Scott Case, Keith Stanberry, Dwight Drain, Sonny Brown, and Tony Rayburn in the secondary for Oklahoma. As Jason Jacobs goes in motion, Archer to throw. Murphy gets a hand on it, bats it away, and it's almost picked off by Dwight Drain. Pretty good effort by Kevin Murphy, who has moved back into a linebacker spot. Oklahoma will do that. As you see, Murphy come over and get a hand on it. Pass intended for Danny Gant. So it'll be a 3rd and 8 situation for Iowa State. First quarter stats.
Quick look, 5 first downs apiece, 154 yards total offense for the Sooners, all on the ground. Iowa State 60 yards passing, 92 total offense, 1 fumble for OU, 7 more plays run by the Cyclones.
Iowa State 3 of 6 in third down conversions. Archer rolls left, looking to throw under pressure. Comes back the other way. Has to run the ball and takes a vicious hit at about the 30-yard line. Kevin Murphy put the hit on David Archer at the 30. That brings the boys up off the bench.
Brings the Iowa State coaching staff out to yell at the officials, too. They thought that was a late hit. Let's watch it again. David Archer showing a little bit more foot speed than I thought he had, as you see Danny Wilson giving chase. Number 98, Rick Bryan, trying to get around a block there. But watch Murphy, 39, coming into your screen, along with time. There's the hit right there, right next to the official. No call.
Kelly Goodburn in punting situation off the side of his foot. Not a good kick. Oklahoma's going to have good field position again. Goodburn comes into the game averaging almost 40 yards a kick, but that was not a good one. 29 yards on the punt. Goodburn, that's the 3rd punt of the day for Goodburn. He's hit a 25-yarder, a 38-yarder, and now a 29-yarder. And Oklahoma will start at their own 41-yard line.
This is the poorest start of the day, I believe, Robbie, for Oklahoma's offense, and they're at their own 41. That is really good field position. So Danny Bradley comes up. Oklahoma 154 yards rushing already, all in the first quarter.
Jerome Ledbetter at fullback now for Oklahoma. Spencer Tillman dots the eye. Wing back reverse to Steve Sewell. Picks up a couple of yards. Doug Fisher on the tackle for Iowa State.
Steve Sewell scored the only touchdown 2 years ago when these two teams played here in Norman, the only Oklahoma touchdown. 16-yard run in the first quarter. Iowa State tied it, and Alex Giffords, their great kicker, had a very short field goal attempt midway through the fourth quarter, and he missed it. And the teams, or Oklahoma, escaped with a 7-7 tie. Sewell on the wing back reverse. Haven't seen that too many times this year.
Sewell's carried the ball 17 times coming into today's game. In the wishbone, handoff, Ledbetter up the middle. Inside Iowa State territory, down to about the 46-yard line. George Walker on the stop. Ledbetter only carried the ball 6 times for 23 yards at the start of today. Picks up some yardage here.
Jerome Ledbetter came to Oklahoma at about 175 pounds. He's beefed up to about 215 now. And Oklahoma fans best remember his kick-returning ability a couple of years ago against Colorado, a 99-yarder that I can remember. He's enjoying this action at fullback, ready to play.
First and 10 for the Sooners from the Iowa State 46. Bradley looking to throw his first pass of the day. Underthrown. Intended for Buster Rhymes. So Bradley 0-1. Oklahoma been running the football well today. That was Bradley's first passing attempt. Bradley came into the ball game hitting almost 41% of his passes, but he is ninth in the conference, unfortunately. Colorado's got a couple of quarterbacks that have had enough attempts to get in the passing charts, so that's why Danny Bradley is ninth in the Big Eight.
And also, Iowa State, though, despite the fact Danny Bradley hasn't thrown for too many yards, Iowa State is last in the Big Eight in pass defense. Well, maybe Oklahoma can get some yards. Buster Rhymes was open on that particular pass attempt, but it was just underthrown a bit. And we understand that OU has gained 5 or more yards now in this ballgame on 10 of their 17 snaps. They've gained more than 5 yards. That's pretty impressive football movement.
And the Sooners are being penalized again for ineligible receiver downfield, so penalties continue to hurt Oklahoma. That's their second penalty of the day. Oklahoma's got 6 first downs. This will be a second and 15 play from the Sooner 49. Bradley on the pitch to Spencer Tillman, who gets to the corner with running room at the 40. Stays in bounds at the 30. Finally run out of bounds inside the 30-yard line, and that's why Spencer Tillman is so dangerous from that tailback spot, as he picks up 15 and made a lot of that yardage on his own.
You got that right, Robbie. It was all Spencer. Watch. You see, Derek Shepard was trying to throw a block. He missed his, and Spencer has to lose George Walker right there, and he gets to the outside. There's a good block, though, by Shepard on the second try, and Tillman got to the boundary, a 15-yard pickup, and the Oklahoma backs are running wild right now. Tillman has 20 yards on 5 carries on the day. That was his longest run.
So Tillman gets the first down. It's now first and 10 for Oklahoma from the Iowa State 34. Sewell comes in motion. Straight handoff up the middle to Ledbetter inside the 30. Pick up a 5 for Jerome Ledbetter. 5'10", 215-pound junior from Muskogee. The only action he has seen this year came in the Kansas State game. All 6 of his carries for 23 yards.
Just straight ahead blocking. Good job of it, too, by Chuck Thomas, the center. Pickett, the freshman, 275-pounder in a rare start for him, doing a great job today, as well as Sidney Dodd and Booger Parker, who's one of the best around.
Paul Clewis and Steve Sewell split wide to the left. The handoff to Tillman up the middle, almost to the 25-yard line. It'll be close to the first down, but they will be short. Oklahoma's got to get to the Iowa State 19 for the first down. To the Iowa State 24. The ball is just outside the 25, so it'll be third and short situation. Clewis goes out of the ball game. Oklahoma is 4 of 4 on third down conversions. They hand the ball to Spencer Tillman, cuts back inside. It'll be close.
We'll just have to see where the referee marks the football. Looks like from up here that he had plenty of yardage for it. Let's watch it on the replay.
I should have known, because Elvin Lindblad, our statistician, marked that thing before they ever marked the ball. So I should have known it was a first down.
That's right. The way Oklahoma's been moving it, you can do that today. They've had a great day.
First and 10 for Oklahoma from the Iowa State 24-yard line. 12-10 to go on the half. Oklahoma in front of Iowa State 14-3. They're in the wishbone. Bradley, option right. Tries to hold on, no place to go. Iowa State does a good job defensively there as Dwayne Gilliard from his linebacker spot there to make the stop on Danny Bradley.
Let's watch 51 in white for Iowa State. He missed four games because of injury, but he was considered to be one of their better backers coming into the game. He just strings out the option real well, reads it, and grabs Danny by the collar and takes him down. So that's the first play that OU has run today that has not gained a yard. Other than that, they've gone north and south very well.
Second and 10 for the Sooners from the Iowa State 24. A handoff to Ledbetter up the middle, inside the 20, down close to the 15-yard line. Jerome Ledbetter running well behind an outstanding job of that offensive line. Sidney Dodd making a pretty good block out there. We've got an injured Iowa State player on the field.
Watch Jerome Ledbetter, just keeps those legs a-going, runs over Dwayne Gilliard there, and Chris Washington, 54, comes in to help out, but not before Jerome picked up some pretty good yardage. We're still trying to see who the Iowa State injured player is on the field that's holding things up.
Iowa State has been bothered by injuries all year, especially on their offense. That entire offensive line, Musgrave, Reimers, Myers, Nelson, and Martin, they have all been injured at one time or another in the early part of the season. 11-18 to go in the first half. Oklahoma 14, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. Linebacker Doug Fisher being helped off the field was the injured Iowa State player. Darren Berryhill comes into the ball game for Oklahoma. Buster Rhymes moves over to the sideline. Danny Bradley, after a chat with the OU coaching staff, comes back out on the field. It'll be third and four for Oklahoma from the Iowa State 17. Oklahoma 5 of 5 in third down conversions. Third and four from the 17. Sewell in motion. The pitch to Spencer Tillman, right side. Dillingham in front. It'll be close to a first down. Spencer Tillman looking for another 100-yard day. He's been shut down the last couple of weeks, just 45 yards against Texas, just 30 yards on the ground against Oklahoma State.
Let's watch the play by Spencer Tillman, and I think we're going to have a measurement as Tillman just cuts it straight up the field and lowers the head, trying to pick up that first down. Sooners already have 8 here in the first half, and let's look at the measurement. There it is.
Another first down for the Oklahoma Sooners, their ninth of the day.
They're now 6 of 6 on third downs, Robbie. That's a big improvement over last week when against the Cowboys, I think they were 2 of 16 or something like that.
And they've done it all on the ground, and that's what Coach Switzer wants to see. Ball control offense on the ground, just as Iowa State will try and control the ball through the air. Oklahoma does it on the ground. They've done an excellent job today already over the 200-yard mark in rushing. First and 10 for the Sooners from the Iowa State 13. Bradley option pitch to Tillman. Makes a cut, can't go anywhere.
Good defense by Iowa State that time. Rodney Hutchins, now he's their defensive utility man, as we call him. He'll line up sometimes in a down spot and then raise up and drop back and play a fifth linebacker. Let's watch the play. Here comes Bradley right side, and good pitch to Tillman. There was a good block thrown out there, I think, by Sewell again, but Hutchins, 96, Chris Washington all in there on a good stop by Iowa State. One of the few times they've been able to avoid a big gainer by Oklahoma on the corner.
Well, they mark the ball at the 14-yard line, so it'll be second and 10, mark it at the 13. Second and 10 from the 13. Derek Shepard in motion. The handoff up the middle, and Ledbetter in the end zone. Touchdown. Jerome Ledbetter from 13 yards out, and Oklahoma's on the board again.
Jerome Ledbetter just went straight up the middle. Great blocking by Chuck Thomas in the right side of that line. Jeff Pickett and Sidney Dodd. That's her, and David Dillingham, who's in the game now, as we see. Watch it. Number 20. He burst past that initial line of pursuit, and it's clear sailing from there. He carried only 6 times coming into today. Jerome Ledbetter off to a good start now. Unofficially 4 carries, 31 yards, and the touchdown.
Lasher comes on for the point after. He drills it. It's good. Exactly 10 minutes to go in the first half, and Oklahoma is out in front of Iowa State 21-3. This is Oklahoma football. The Oklahoma offense looking for some consistency, which in hopes would bring some confidence to the offensive unit, and they've put 3 touchdowns on the board here in 1 quarter and 5 minutes. So the Oklahoma offense on a roll right now, as you take a look at Jim Williams, the offensive line coach for Iowa State, has got a son that plays on this Iowa State football team, as Tim Lasher tees it up, getting ready to kick deep to Richard Hansen, who is standing at about the 3-yard line. When they were going the other way in the first quarter, Hansen was deep in the end zone. Last time he brought it out from about 8 yards deep in the end zone. Tim Lasher ready. He boots it away. That's a strong leg for Tim Lasher as he puts up the end zone, and Hansen's going to bring it out again to the 15. He's hit it about the 17. Ball forward to about the 19-yard line. Boy, Tim Lasher, Coach Switzer talked about Lasher last week, and what a better job Oklahoma has been doing in the kicking game as you take another look at Richard Hansen, who brings it out from the end zone.
Special team and field position look like Tony Rayburn, I think, on the initial hit down there. And Iowa State starts at their 19. That touchdown by Jerome Ledbetter moments ago, his first touchdown since 1980. He scored 4 touchdowns in the 80 season. Of course, redshirted in 81, didn't score last year.
Archer to throw on first down from his own 19. Intended for Jason Jacobs. Intercepted by Keith Stanberg. That is the second interception of the year for Stanberg.
Let's watch the play again. David Archer, a sprint out pass to the left. And it looked like the pass was thrown just a bit too tall. No, actually, it hit Jason Jacobs right in the hands. I'm sorry. And Stanberry picks it up, his second Oscar of the year. You remember, he picked one off against Oklahoma State and ran it back, but it was called back for a touchdown. It was called back because of the penalty. So Oklahoma, again, tremendous field position starting at the Iowa State 33.
Just 33 yards to go to get some more points on the board. 9:49 to go. The Sooners are in the eye. Jerome Johnson at the top of the eye. Bradley looking to throw on first down. Scrambles out of trouble. Going to run the football at the 30, the 25, the 20, 15, 10, 5. Out of bounds at about the 2-yard line.
And the key to that play, no penalty flag. The way Danny Bradley scrambled for a 30-yard run, I was looking for penalty flags for maybe a clip, but just a great job by Danny Bradley of guiding his offensive players. Steve Sewell pointing out a block, and Bradley goes for 30 yards inside the 5 to the Iowa State 4. Let's look at it again.
And we'll see if at the end of this we'll notice Danny Bradley is limping. Bradley getting out of trouble. That is why he is so dangerous. Not so much that he's a great passer, but he is so dangerous in a passing situation. Finally run out of bounds by Kevin Williams. A handoff is to Alvin Ross up the middle, no gain. Maybe a couple.
Bradley was limping just a little bit after that 30-yard run, but he looks to be okay now. I think he's so tickled with the way things are going, he'll stay in there for just a bit. He's having a good time out there. Oklahoma's rushing game nearing the 250-yard mark here, and we're plenty of ways away from halftime. 9 minutes to go. They're averaging 261 coming into the game. They are rolling up a lot of yards on that Iowa State defense, which has to start thinking about getting tired here.
Second and goal from the 2 for Oklahoma. A handoff to Earl Johnson. Freezes into the end zone. Big hole. Earl Johnson scores for the Oklahoma Sooners, and just like that, it is now 27-3.
Some tremendous blocking by Brent Burks and Paul Parker, two of the finer members of the Oklahoma offensive line. And you saw it. Earl Johnson was not even touched when he went into the end zone. And Oklahoma is on their way to their biggest scoring day of the season. 27, trying to make it 28-3 with Tim Lasher, and 8:59 to go in the half.
Fourth touchdown of the year for Earl Johnson as Lasher comes on to add his fourth point after the ball's down. The kick is up, and it's good. 8:59 to go in the first half. The route may be on. Oklahoma 28, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. Danny Bradley hands off to Earl Johnson. Big hole left side, and Earl Johnson breezes into the end zone, his fourth touchdown of the year. Earl Johnson now has 89 yards on 6 carries. Tim Lasher getting ready to tee the ball up as you take a look at those numbers.
That's all on the ground, by the way. Oklahoma, 248 yards rushing, no passing. You see Richard Hansen back there wondering when he's going to try and pop a long one, because the offense has been shut down so far by this Oklahoma defense that seems to have adjusted well to the passing game.
A low kick headed for Johnson or Hansen at the 2-yard line, right straight up the middle, and he is hit at about the 24-yard line. That's where Iowa State will start on their sixth possession. They have had terrible field position, a 22-yard return by Richard Hansen. Iowa State has started from their own 20 as you take a look at Hansen again up the middle. Tony Rayburn gets the initial hit, then he gets some help. Iowa State has started from their own 20, their own 20, their own 9, their own 27, their own 19, and now their own 24. Jacobs is the lone setback for Iowa State. And the pitch goes to Jacobs, right side. Almost gets away from Kevin Murphy, but the junior from Plano, Texas holds on. Jacobs is going to lose a couple of yards.
That's why Kevin Murphy's the leading tackler in the Big 8. Just watch number 39 again. He pops through, makes the hit, the initial hit. Now, Jason Jacobs is hard to bring down, but Murphy wraps him up around the ankles. He had 80 tackles coming into the game, the leader in the Big 8 Conference, and he's off to another great day today.
Second and 10 for Iowa State from their own 24. Archer calling signals for Iowa State, straight back to pass. And he finds his man, Tracy Henderson, the leading receiver in the Big 8 Conference, 13th in the nation. 6 foot, 180-pound sophomore from Maywood, Illinois. Came into the ball game with 35 receptions on the day, a pickup of 14 for Iowa State.
Archer, plenty of time this time on the straight drop back, and here is the pass to Henderson, who gets past Tony Rayburn and out of bounds. He's the leader in the Big 8, but he's had a tough time of it today. Iowa State, Robbie, only 13 yards total offense here in the second quarter.
First and 10 from their own 38. Jacobs at setback. The hand goes to Jacobs across the 40-yard line up to about the 42. Iowa State does not run the ball very much. Their last 2 weeks, they have rushed for 133 yards against Colorado. They rushed for 127 against Kansas. But they've had games like 42 on the ground, 21 on the ground, 80, 31. They live and die by the pass. Jim Kreiner, after 7 years at Boise State, brings Air Kreiner to Ames, Iowa. Second and 6 for the Cyclones from their own 42. Archer to throw to his tight end, Jeff Watka. Boy, what a hit Watka takes by Tony Rayburn.
Rayburn's making his presence felt both on the specialty teams and there in the defensive backfield coming in that nickel defense situation. He's from Douglas, a 6'3", 200-pound freshman, Tony Rayburn, number 35, who has made a couple of pops on the kickoffs the last two times.
Sooners using 5 defensive backs. They've got Kevin Murphy lined up as a linebacker. Danny Gant splits wide left for Iowa State. Henderson is wide right. Jacobs the setback, Archer back to pass. Across the middle, he's got his man, Tracy Henderson, at about the 41-yard line.
Well, let's watch this combination. It's worked often this time, or many times this season. David Archer, this was just a great pass. He threads the needle, 2 or 3 people covering Tracy Henderson across, and Henderson slides in safely with his grab. Roy Owens in the ball game defending from Tulsa, Washington, and Keith Stanberry, but a good completion for Iowa State. And Archer now unofficially has put it up, completed 11 passes for 91 yards.
Tracy Henderson with 5 catches today. First down play for Iowa State from the Oklahoma 42. Trying to run the ball with Jason Jacobs. A host of Sooners there to meet him. Picks up just a couple. Take a look at this Oklahoma defense.
The league leaders in the Big 8 in every category, and Jason Jacobs tries to run over his offensive tackle. You see the initial hit there. Looks by like Jackie Shipp, and I tell you what, Jacobs difficult to bring down. Finally brought down by Casillas and a host of red-shirted Sooners.
It'll be second down for Iowa State from the Oklahoma 38-yard line. Second and 7. They need to get to the Oklahoma 31. Now we've got timeout on the field as David Archer comes over to talk to the coaching staff. Didn't like the alignment, so there's timeout on the field. 6:03 to go before halftime. Iowa State trying to get some points on the board. Oklahoma leads Iowa State 28-3. This is Oklahoma football. Take a look at some of the spirit on the sidelines here at Owen Field, and there's the pride of Oklahoma. And boy, Coach Switzer gave them a game ball last week. Interesting story, an emotional week for Oklahoma as they get ready to play the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And 3 days last week, Oklahoma band came out to practice and whipped up Boomer Sooner all day long. As you take a look at Oklahoma out in front 28-3, and after the ball game, the entire Oklahoma football team went down and stood in front of the Oklahoma band, waved at them, said thank you very much, and Coach Switzer gave the pride of Oklahoma a game ball last week for their efforts in the Oklahoma come-from-behind win over Oklahoma State 21-20. It is second down and seven for Iowa State at the Sooner 38-yard line. No backs. Archer throws across the middle. He's got Jason Jacobs, who gets to the 30-yard line. That'll be good for the first down.
An 8-yard pickup for Jason Jacobs that time, who lined up in kind of a slot back position. And it was just a quick slant in across the middle. Archer hits Jacobs in a hurry, an 8-yard pickup. And that time, no backs in the backfield for Iowa State. We've seen a lot of multiple sets for the Cyclones, as expected, coming in today. And already here in the first half, they've put up about 17 passes.
Jacobs is out. Tommy Davis is the lone setback now for Iowa State. The pitch goes to Davis around the right side, a run out of bounds by Kevin Murphy. Pickup of just a couple for Tommy Davis. Second team all Big Eight last year.
Look at number 22. He's Iowa State's most elusive runner, kind of the Sooners equivalent to Spencer Tillman. But in this situation, running to the short side of the field, he didn't have a whole lot of room. And Kevin Murphy ran him down from behind. We've mentioned number 39, Murphy, a lot today. He's off to another great start. 5:42 to go on the half. Sooners leading 28-3.
It's a second down play for Iowa State, second to seven from the Sooner 27. Jacobs comes in motion. And the throw goes to Jacobs, who makes the reception at the 20-yard line. Brought down from behind by Jackie Schiff from his linebacker spot. John Truitt also there to help out. Take another look at David Archer throwing to Jason Jacobs.
Jacobs ran a slant this time and then cut back to the outside, a flag pattern in the middle, if you want to call it that. And that's why he's caught 28 passes coming into today's game. He's caught three today unofficially. So Jacobs very valuable, not only running the football but also on the receiving end. And Iowa State now in four down territory inside the Sooner 20-yard line.
First and 10 for Iowa State as they're knocking on the Sooner door. 5:20 to go before halftime. Davis and Jacobs, the split backs. Archer straight back to throw. He's got time, overthrows his intended receiver, Tommy Davis.
Good coverage over there on the boundary by John Truitt, who was in the game and back there a little bit with some help from Sonny Brown, I believe. Oklahoma that time just had the play snuffed out, and Archer just threw it away. He was a little bit too close to the boundary, got rid of it. David on the day now 12 of 19 for 108 yards, but Oklahoma has done a good job since that initial drive in the first quarter, which Iowa State went down the field and got their field goal. Oklahoma has adjusted well on defense to this crazy offense, wide open to say the least.
Danny Gant splits wide right, couple of wide outs on the left side, or right side, Robbie Miner. Archer to throw again. Can't find anybody, runs it up the middle, finally brought down by Tommy Flemons at about the 15-yard line. Be pickup of about five for David Archer as the clock is running. We're under the five-minute mark now. It'll be third and five for Iowa State from the Oklahoma 15-yard line.
Here's David Archer back to pass, and he just has to run up the middle. Everybody's covered. Rick Bryan and Flemons give chase, and Archer finally tackled after a five-yard gain. Iowa State on the day, 5 of 8 on third down conversion.
Those numbers on that last graphic have just been in the last five games. He's thrown for more than 1,300 yards this year overall. Jason Jacobs on the handoff up the middle, moves off to the left side and gets close to the 10-yard line. He'll be short of the first down. We'll see what Iowa State elects to do here. A field goal doesn't really do you much good when you're trailing 28-3 with 4 minutes and 15 seconds left in the first half. So Iowa State is going to go for it. It'll be fourth and one from the Oklahoma 11-yard line. David Archer has made more attempts and more completions this year than anybody in the Big 8 Conference, leads the league in touchdown passes. Iowa State's in a wishbone. Now Jacobs is in motion. The hand of Tommy Davis is swarmed under, and Iowa State does not get the first down. The Oklahoma defense has held.
Kevin Murphy, once again, number 39. Let's watch the play. Here's Archer, and it'll be help from Shipp and Dwight Drain. Watch it. Murphy, number 39 there, the first one to make the hit. And then there's Tommy Flemons, Dwight Drain, everybody coming up for run support, and there was no chance for the Cyclones on that play.
So the Oklahoma Sooner defense has done the job. Just as the offense has put 28 points on the board, the defense keeps Iowa State out of the end zone. Oklahoma starts first and 10 from their own 13, their worst field position of the day. By far, they're in the eye. Sewell's in motion. Mike Clopton, the quarterback, throwing deep for Buster Rhymes. He's got it. Oh, doctor, Mike Clopton in the ball game. 44 yards to Buster Rhymes.
Mike Clopton, who played in a sparing role last week against Oklahoma State when Danny Bradley was shaken up for a time, comes in and on his first play airs it out for 44 yards. That's Oklahoma's first pass attempt of the day. They complete it. 44 big yards. They're in Iowa State territory at the 43 again.
Clopton just 2 of 6 on the year in his limited playing time, in for 4 pass attempts against Kansas State, 2 against Oklahoma State. Sewell goes in motion. Clopton hands to Jerome Ledbetter, tries to dance around people and falls down at the 40-yard line. Pickup of 3. Tackle made by Gibson and Little for Iowa State.
Let's watch Jerome this time. He just about went to the dance. If he could have gotten over this one player, he'd have had some yards. But 93 trips him up right there for a short gain, 3 yards. And the defensive stop by Iowa State, a little bit fortunate on that play because Ledbetter had some room around the right side.
Mike Clopton, the quarterback, Danny Bradley on the sideline. Don't know the extent of Bradley's problem. He was limping around earlier. Sewell comes in motion. Clopton option right side. The pitch to Tillman. He's run out of bounds at about the 36. Run out of bounds by Billy McHugh, a 5'10", 185-pound junior from Aurora, Illinois. He leads the Iowa State team in tackles for defensive backs. He was a starter this year until Alvin Baker moved over from cornerback to the strong safety spot. As you take another look at Tillman being bounced out of bounds by Billy McHugh. A third down play for Oklahoma. They are 6 of 6 on third down conversions today. Third and 3 from the Iowa State 36. Clopton at the controls. Oklahoma in the eye. Spencer Tillman stops and starts, and he's going to be short of the first down. Steve Little there to make the stop for the Iowa State Cyclones. The crowd of 75,000 wants the Oklahoma Sooners to go for it.
Watch the good defense here by the Cyclones. Looks like Steve Little, and it does look like the Sooners will go for it. Tim Lasher started into the ballgame momentarily, but he stayed over there, and Coach Switzer confident in the way his team has moved the football. They'll go for it on a fourth down.
Fourth and 2 for Oklahoma from the 35-yard line. Clapton option, pitch to Tillman, got some room. Puts a move and gets inside the 25. And a flag goes down. Put a move on Billy McHugh to get away and get the first down, but now we'll have to wait and see what the flag is. Pickup of 11 for Spencer Tillman.
Have a couple of flags down there on the right boundary. Might be a late hit. That's just one opinion. Could be a personal foul against the Cyclones. They're talking about it in front of the Sooner bench. But nonetheless, a great play. Good pitch by Mike Clopton, Robbie. He's not known for being an option quarterback. He got rid of that football in a hurry and put it where it had to be, and Tillman did the rest. So we'll wait and see for the official's indication here.
Good point, Bob. Mike Clopton, a junior college transfer, known for his passing ability. A personal foul against Iowa State. Sooners got the first down anyway. They're going to have some more yardage tacked on now. Take a look at Mike Clopton on the option.
Pretty good read by Mike. He got rid of it in a hurry. Rodney Hutchins had him around the ankles. And here goes Spencer, who slipped down, or he might have been in the end zone, which would have given Oklahoma their biggest scoring total of the day. Billy McHugh on the tackle, and there is the late shot. So Iowa State goes 15 more back the other way. And Oklahoma now inside the Iowa State 15, down about the 12-yard line.
Alvin Baker whistled for the personal foul. Alvin Baker, a 6-foot senior from Tampa, Florida, the starting left cornerback until 2 weeks ago. Now the Sooners are in the eye. First and 10 from the Iowa State 12. Here's Derek Shepherd on the wing back reverse, and boy, is he met by Chris Washington. No place to go for the little guy from Odessa, Texas, Derek Shepherd.
And Robbie, your favorite player was also in on the tackle. Our camera people got picked up. There's the 10th Tasmanian Devil, too.
Right.
Lester Williams.
Lester Williams.
They call him the Tasmanian Devil because of his reckless play, and he was pretty reckless on that play.
And he stacks up Derek Shepherd for a loss of four, so it'll be second and 15. They've marked it at the 17-yard line. So second and 15 from the Iowa State 17, prompting the throw. He's got Spencer Tillman at the 10. A move into the end zone. Touchdown, Spencer Tillman, his second of the day.
Well, a nice pass by Mike Clopton. He just put it out there with a nice, easy, feather-like touch. And Tillman did the rest, and Spencer's putting on a show. Let's watch Mike Clopton. Now, this is a lot more difficult pass than you would think, folks, because you have to throw it just right and lead the ball carrier, who in this case is very fast. Tillman, perfect route, and this time Clopton lays it out there perfectly for Spencer, who takes it, puts a move on it about the five, and gets into the end zone. And this is the most points an Oklahoma team has scored in a game this year. They lead 34-3.
Now, I'll make it 35-3 as Lasher adds the point after. 1:30 to go in the first half. Oklahoma 35, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. Take a look at Mike Clopton. His first touchdown pass of the year. Only the second reception of the year for Spencer Tillman coming out of the backfield. Made the reception at the 10, put the move on Kevin Williams. Dances into the end zone, and this is just what the doctor ordered. Coach Switzer told us earlier in the week they really needed to blow somebody out, give that offense some confidence, and with a minute and a half left in the first half, Oklahoma out in front 35-3. Lasher's got it teed up. Richard Hansen is deep for Iowa State. Lasher boots it away. It's going to carry into the end zone. Hansen wants to bring it out again. He's at the 10, at the 15. Sonny Brown makes the tackle at the 21.
It's a good thing Sonny Brown made that open field stop because Hansen had a little bit of room around the left side. Let's watch it again. As Hansen is a daredevil back there, he will not hesitate to bring it out of the end zone. Mike Mantle missed the tackle there, and there's Sonny Brown, number 8, who makes the stop at about the 22-yard line. Once again, Iowa State deep in their own territory following an Oklahoma 87-yard drive in 8 plays. The touchdown play, a 17-yard pass, or 13 yards from Mike Clopton to Spencer Tillman.
So Oklahoma gets a long drive on the board. Iowa State starts from their own 22. 1:24 to go in the half. Oklahoma in front 35-3. Archer rolls right, looking to throw over the middle. He's got Tracy Henderson. Tracy Henderson is really a talent, a 6-foot, 180-pound sophomore from Maywood, Illinois. Take another look at David Archer. Henderson, earlier in the year in the Kansas ball game, had 10 receptions for 139 yards. He makes another reception there.
And Tracy Henderson, the only freshman to earn a varsity letter on Iowa State's team last season. He now has 6 catches in today's game for 53 yards. We're still in the first half, so he might break that record he set against Kansas.
Archer brings the clones to the line. First down, Archer throws to the near boundary. He's got Danny Gant, a 6'3 sophomore from Cerritos, California. Pick up a 5 or 6. See where they mark it. They mark it almost exactly at the 40-yard line, just short of the 40. That's the 10th first down of the day for Iowa State. On the previous play, that play picked up 7, second and 3 from the 40.
Just a little flat pass. Archer again out here on the right side. They're very high on Danny Gant. They think he's going to be yet another fine receiver for Iowa State in the future, the JUCO transfer from Cerritos, California.
Split backs for Iowa State. Archer straight back to pass. Looking for Henderson. A flag goes down. Archer rolls. Now throws. Holy cow. Scott Case really put a hit on Tommy Davis out of the backfield. It's good enough for the first down. We'll see what the flag is. Scott Case, a vicious hit on Tommy Davis. The officials are conferring. Tommy Fleming's in there listening. Bob Slater, number 68.
From David Archer's indication, it would look like it's against the Cyclones, and it is, holding I believe that's the third call, and, well, we'll have two penalties against the Cyclones. Holding and illegal procedure. Let's watch the play, though. Archer gets away. Might have the hold there on 67, I believe, and there's another one against Bob Slater. Here's Archer rolling right side, and he'll get it to Tommy Davis, but watch the pop at the end of the play. Scott Case. Ooh.
So Iowa State will be marked off for another penalty as Iowa State has to help a player off the field, Joe Jackson.
It's been that kind of a day for Iowa State, tough one.
Well, Jackson was injured earlier, and he's got his ankle all wrapped up in ice, and he's heading for the locker room. That'll probably be all for Joe Jackson, who is a junior college transfer for Iowa State. It is now second and 13 for Iowa State from their own 30-yard line. Archer back, throwing deep. White Drain on the coverage. Pass intended for Robbie Miner, but way overthrown. White Drain was there, so it'll be a third down play for Iowa State. As you take a look at their band, who made the trip from Ames, Iowa, talking to Buck Turnbull in the hall a little earlier today, writes for the Des Moines Register, one of the veterans of the Big 8 Conference, said they had a little snow up in Ames, Iowa. So even though we don't have perfect weather here in Norman, it could be worse, couldn't it?
It could be. Iowa State, after their start, 1-3, they thought it was going to be a long, cold winter, but they've come on to win their last two Big 8 games. So the 3-3 coming into today, and it's odd to see an Iowa State team tied for the Big 8 lead.
Third and 13 from the 30. Archer back to get the yardage. She throws over the middle. He's got Gant. A pretty good hit put on him by Sonny Brown, but Gant makes the reception. Interesting story about Danny Gant. He is a transfer. He's a sophomore, played 1 year at Cerritos Junior College in California as he just got the wind knocked out of him. But he didn't arrive on the Iowa State campus until September 8th. You have to practice for 10 days before you can play in a game. Gant missed the first four games of the year, as you see Sonny Brown put the hit on him, and now Gant has worked himself into a major role here for the Iowa State Cyclones in their passing attack. He had four receptions for 50 yards coming into today's game. He had three catches last week, including a touchdown pass against Colorado. 35 seconds left in the first half. Oklahoma 35, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. A first down for the Iowa State Cyclones from midfield. Archer looks for all of it. He's got it way overthrown, and Archer really took a hit just as he released that ball. A pass intended for Robbie Miner and Tracy Henderson, but David Archer paid for throwing that pass.
Good rush by the Sooners. Watch it again. Archer goes back, and this is the second time he's tried to throw deep here in the last minute or so. Both times he's overthrown the receiver. Rick Bryan, the man who meets David Archer the hard way, and the ball is overthrown. Couple of Cyclone receivers down there. Henderson and Miner. Could have been a busted pattern. Both players running in that same vicinity. Dwight Drain on the coverage for Oklahoma.
27 seconds left in the half. Second and 10 from midfield for Iowa State. Archer to throw. Throws it out of bounds. Intended for Danny Gant. So it'll be a third down play. That only took 4 seconds. It might take us 4 days to play this game.
The last minute has gone slow. There's Jim Kreiner, who has coached under some good ones. Pepper Rogers, Dick Vermeil at UCLA, Lavelle Edwards at BYU. He's been to the big schools, and he's anxious to coach here in the Big 8 Conference and showing everybody that he knows what he's doing.
He made a comment earlier in the week that this is a great challenge for Iowa State. The Cyclones looking forward to the opportunity of playing a team like the Oklahoma Sooners. Third and 10 for Iowa State from midfield. Archer looks. He's under pressure, and down he goes. Second sack of the day for the Oklahoma defense.
Danny Wilson, the 6'2", 255-pounder from Sherman, Texas, in on the sack, and Iowa State will be forced to punt after the 8-yard loss. Watch it. Look at 98, straight over the center, and he'll come in with help from several others. Wilson just powered past the offensive lineman to make that sack an 8-yard loss, and I think we will see a timeout by Oklahoma. Kelly Goodburn into the game to punt.
Fourth sack of the day, or fourth sack of the year for Danny Wilson, as you take a look at OU head coach Barry Switzer. The winningest coach in America, never lost to Iowa State. The Iowa State huddle, Jim Kreiner, in his first year at Iowa State, started the year by losing big to Iowa at home, 51-10. Then they went on the road to Vanderbilt, lost 29-26, a game they should have won. Then they returned home the next week, beat Colorado State 21-17. Then they lost a home game to New Mexico State, and that's when Kreiner really went on the warpath, said he wanted to get 22 tough players out there, and every position on the team was open. I guess it must have worked, because then they came back and beat Kansas 38-35, and last week beat Colorado 22-10. It's fourth down for Iowa State. Kelly Goodburn in punting situation. Derek Shepherd is deep for Oklahoma. 5 seconds left. Iowa State fakes the punt. It doesn't make any difference. The clock runs out. The first half is history. And Oklahoma leads Iowa State 35-3. We'll be back in just a minute. Been elected to take the second half option. So Oklahoma will be receiving here to start the second ball game. As you take a look at Danny Bradley on the sidelines, number one, don't know the extent of his injury.
Well, Bradley had that baseball cap on there late in the second quarter when Mike Clopton was in the game and guided the Sooners on a touchdown drive. He's standing next to Jim Rockford, who is also not playing today because of an injury. So we'll have to see who, if Clopton obviously will start the second half deep for Oklahoma. Number four, Buster Rhymes, and number three, Derek Shepherd, to return this kickoff. Remember, Rhymes took the opening kickoff 39 yards in the first half.
Well, and we may be speaking a little quickly as back road kicks it deep. Rhymes will take it at about the four, up the middle to the 20 and across the 20. You know, maybe Danny Bradley is not hurt. Maybe Coach Switzer feels like 35-3 is good enough. As you take a look at the Oklahoma offense, Clopton will be the starting quarterback, Johnson at tailback, Ross at fullback, Rhymes the split end, Fontenette tight end, and Steve Sewell will be the wingback.
Well, there's no doubt that Oklahoma needs to get Mike Clopton with some snaps, as you see the offensive line. Burks, Parker, Thomas, Pickett, and Dodd to start this second half. Mike Clopton would have to be thrown in there, of course, if anything happened to Danny Bradley, and he's had a lack of snaps this year. So Clopton gets the start as we're underway in the second half, 35-3 Oklahoma.
First and 10 for the Sooners from their own 23. The hand is to Earl Johnson, and he is met quickly by Steve Little. 6'3", 237-pound junior from Peoria, Illinois. He leads the Iowa State team in tackles for down linemen.
And let's take a look at number 93, who is right there on Earl Johnson as soon as he touches the football. It's a minus one, a one-yard loss, as we look at the Cyclones defense. Lester, the Tasmanian Devil there at defensive end. Barry Moore, Steve Little, Rodney Hutchins, and Jim Lubers, who is listed as a defensive end, but he's really a linebacker. Chris Washington, Dwayne Gilliard, Jackson Williams, Baker, and George Walker are the defensive backs.
Ross, the fullback, Johnson, the tailback. The pitch comes to Earl Johnson. He gets across the 25 and up to about the 27-yard line before he is brought down by Barry Moore and other Cyclones. Kevin Williams from a cornerback spot up there to help on the tackle.
No doubt Iowa State made a few adjustments at halftime. The Sooners rolled up almost 270 yards rushing. They string out the play here well, and some good lateral pursuit to bring down Oklahoma for a short gain. Iowa State hoping to do the same thing Tulsa did when Oklahoma had their best first half of the year earlier, leading 28-0 at halftime and didn't score a point in the second half.
Third and six from the 27 for the Sooners. They're 6 of 7 on third down conversions today. Clopton to throw for it. He's got Rhymes out of bounds at about the 34-yard line. See where they marked the ball. He's got enough for the first down. Pickup of 7. So Clopton goes to the air again, gives the Sooners a first down. First and 10 at the Iowa State. We'll mark it at the 34-yard line.
Mike Clopton was the fifth leading passer in junior college quarterbacks in the country a year ago, and he hits Buster Rhymes there like a rope. A great passer, Clopton. He really puts some zip on the ball, and you can tell he is not a freshman. With that junior college experience, he is cool and calm under pressure and put the ball right where it had to be.
Hand off to Ross up the middle for just a couple. Gets just beyond the 35-yard line. Ross, a sophomore out of Aurora, Illinois. Lester Williams and Barry Moore on the tackle. Mark it just beyond the 35-yard line, so it'll be second and 8 for Oklahoma from the Iowa State 35.
Alvin Ross, pretty good first half for him. 2 carries for 19 yards. That's his third carry of the game. And he had only 6, I believe, coming into this game in previous games this season.
Sewell and Rhymes, the receivers. Sewell goes in motion. Rhymes is split left. Option to Johnson at the 40, up to the 45 before he's run out of bounds. Dwayne Gilliard and Kevin Williams there to run Earl Johnson out of bounds. Injured earlier in the ball game, came back to score a touchdown. Johnson scored on a 2-yard run. Take another look at the pitch.
Well, this is why Earl Johnson and Spencer Tillman will alternate. Johnson is the one that runs straight ahead, the slasher that runs over you, whereas when you put Tillman in there, it's a whole new dimension. He's the elusive one that runs away from people, and that's why Coach Switzer likes that blend and plans on playing these two gentlemen an equal amount of time.
Johnson over the 100-yard mark now, 102 yards. Hand off to Ross up the middle for absolutely nothing. Steve Little, the strongest player on the Iowa State team, there to make the stop. Number 93, Steve Little.
Looks like there's a few angry Cyclones down there after that first half trouncing. And this time, Little and Moore in there. Steve Little just meets Alvin Ross head on and knocks him down for a loss. Cyclones look a little bit better defensively to start the second half.
Well, they've made improvement throughout the year. They gave up 535 yards total offense in their season opener against Iowa. They have done better as the season progresses. Clopton calling signals, second and 12 for Oklahoma. Throws to Steve Sewell, makes a nice catch at the 45. Still on his feet. They can't get him down. Finally at the 40-yard line. Steve Sewell doing a nice piece of work there as he picks up 17 yards on the reception from Clopton.
I was a little bit surprised how Iowa State laid back on that particular pass play. Steve Sewell caught the football, as we'll see, and had 9 or 10 yards to run before anybody was near him. Here's Clopton, throws it up high, and a nice catch by Steve Sewell, who seems to have rebounded from his problems with catching the ball at the first of the season. You see no defenders in the picture at all until Billy McHugh tries to get Sewell down. 17-yard pickup, first and 10 Sooners just inside the Iowa State 40.
Sewell started the day with 6 receptions, averaging almost 10 yards a reception. Clopton option right, pitch to Johnson, a block in front of him, and he gets close to the 30-yard line. Alvin Ross throwing the lead block for Earl Johnson on the corner. Billy McHugh and Dwayne Gilliard on the stop. Take another look at Clopton, who does a good job of running the option here.
Alvin Ross helps out there in front a little bit, and Earl just follows his blockers for a quick gain. Clopton in the game here, starting the second half at quarterback. No injury, we don't think, to Danny Bradley. Just a chance to give Mike Clopton some playing time, and he's completed 3 of 4 passes for 85 yards.
Sooners come out on a second and short situation, second and 1 from the Iowa State 31. They're in the eye. The hand to Alvin Ross, cuts back inside the 30, inside the 25. Alvin Ross picking up some good yardage up the middle. Pickup of 7. Ross came into the ball game with just 9 carries for 28 yards, averaging a little better than 3 yards a carry, but he's getting some work today. There you see Chris Washington wrap up Alvin Ross. Washington, the leading tackler on the Iowa State team. He led the Big 8 Conference in unassisted tackles last year with 98. He's an All-America candidate if Iowa State has one. A handoff to Ross again, and Iowa State defensive line doing a good job there and getting some help from the linebackers as Doug Fisher is there to make the stop, a 6-foot, 220-pound senior from Massillon, Ohio. Some pretty good players and coaches have come out of that town. There you see Alvin Ross hit the brick wall. It'll be second down now and 11. Give Ross a loss of 1 on that play. Sewell and Rhymes. Sewell split to the far side of the field. Sewell split to the near side. Rhymes to the top of the screen. And there's a pass almost picked off by Billy McHugh. If Clopton had waited just another second or so, that he might have had Rhymes open, but Billy McHugh almost picked that off, hit him in a bad spot.
Well, let's watch the play. Looked like maybe a mix-up on the pattern because Mike just got rid of it in a hurry before the receiver was open, and McHugh saw it all the way. He had the ball in his hands. Might have had a little bit of room up that boundary, but couldn't hold on, and the Sooners avoid a problem there, and they'll still have the football coming up on a 3rd and 11.
Sooners have made 7 of 8 third-down attempts today. This is 3rd and 11 from the 26. Clopton rolls left. Looking to throw, and throws it behind Buster Rhymes. They got mixed up there.
Buster was open, and once again, that's probably just a lack of experience or playing time behind the stick for Mike Clopton. But Buster Rhymes open, you have to credit Clopton for getting out of some trouble there. He rolled out. He's not normally a rollout passer. And the Sooner crowd, an appreciative one of over 75,000, gives Oklahoma a round of applause as Tim Lasher comes in. Here's the play. Clopton rolls and threw toward the sideline, whereas Rhymes had done more or less a hook to the inside, and the ball fell incomplete.
This will be a 43-yard attempt for Tim Lasher, who is 3 of 5 in the field goal department this year. He's hit his last 3 in a row. including that 46-yarder to beat Oklahoma State last week. The 43-yard kick is up. It's long enough. It's no good. Off to the right, Tim Lasher misses a 43-yard field goal attempt, so the Iowa State defense is held. Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State, 35-3, 9:53 to go in the third quarter. Oklahoma 35, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. Look at some of the crowd here as Archer goes back to pass on first down. He's got Jason Jacobs over the middle. Up across the 40-yard line as Archer, as expected, comes out throwing the football, a pickup of 15. That play started at the Iowa State 21-yard line. Jason Jacobs makes the reception, the second leading receiver on the Iowa State team. Jacobs is a transfer from Highland, Kansas Junior College, a teammate there of linebacker Dwayne Gilliard. It's first and 10 for Iowa State from their own 40. They trail 35-3. The lone setback is Tommy Davis. The pitch goes to Davis, left side, no place to go, and he's swarmed under. It'll be a loss of 3 for Tommy Davis.
Great pursuit by Dwight Drain, who read the play from the start, along with Kevin Murphy. Now watch this lateral pursuit. This is why Oklahoma's defense leads the Big Eight. They are so fast and difficult to get around. Good play by Bob Slater staying in there tough. And there's Murphy along with Dwight Drain to throw the ball carrier for a loss. Iowa State now, since about midway through the second quarter, as we look at the total offense figures, Oklahoma almost 400 yards already. Iowa State has lined up many, many times without any backs in the backfield. They like to put Jason Jacobs in that slot back position, and that's how they line up again.
Second and 13 from the 38 for Iowa State. Archer to throw the football again. Goes deep, and he's got Robbie Miner all by himself and crashes into a photographer. The ball was overthrown, but what a collision out of bounds. It's dangerous when you've got a camera on your shoulder and you're trying to find the football. Robbie Miner bounces up, but nobody else down there is going to bounce up when you've got a guy running full speed and he runs right over you.
Well, they're attending to the photographer down there and the equipment more than anything. Looks like the young lady's okay.
Yeah.
That can be a serious problem. It brings to mind Forrest Ballora a couple years ago, the Oklahoma tight end in the Texas game that bashed into a network camera right before the game and suffered a big gash on his forehead. Watch again. This was a play where Robbie Miner was wide open. As Scott Case took to the inside, Miner broke outside. And look at how open as we get back to the play.
Third down play. Archer to throw forward over the middle, almost picked off by Sonny Brown. That pass wasn't close, and Sonny Brown got his hands on it, but the freshman from Alice, Texas couldn't hold on. But the Oklahoma defense holds, and Iowa State will be forced to punt. Kelly Goodburn, 6'2", 203-pound junior from Cushing, Iowa, kicks the ball away for Iowa State, but the whistle blows. We're going to start this over. As a flag goes down on the field, there was some concern this year whether or not the Iowa State punter, Kelly Goodburn, would even be playing this year. He broke a leg last year in the Missouri game. As we take a look at the infraction illegal procedure against Iowa State. And then this summer, Goodburn was involved with burglary charges. And at one point, he was not welcome back to the team, but son of a gun, here he is.
Yeah, eventually, I was talking to Kirk Hendricks, the sports information director at Iowa State. He said Goodburn was dismissed. He appealed to a university appeals tribunal who said okay, and they reversed the decision and then said if the team votes you back, you can play. And the Iowa State team voted Kelly Goodburn to return to this team, so that is why he is playing. 30.6 yard average today, his longest punt, a 38-yarder. He needs a good one here to get the Cyclones out of a hole.
He's got the longest punt of the year in the Big 8 Conference. He hit a 71-yarder against Colorado State. He's got a punt away toward Derek Shepard at the 20. Got some running room at the 30. Cuts back, still on his feet. Now he's got the boundary. At the 40, needs a block. He gets it. Cuts back the other way. At the 40, up the middle of the 30. And down inside, close to the 25-yard line. A great return by Derek Shepard. 46 yards on the punt, a 52-yard return.
Let's watch Darrell Shepard. He came into the game just averaging about 8.5 yards of return, and this guy can cut back and use his blockers. Watch the way he tries to find that wall. He eludes Jim Lubers there, picks up a few blocks, one of them from Mitch Bryan, and now he finds the crease to the outside, has to cut back inside. Scott Case trying to knock down Goodburn, who we thought was the last man that would have a chance. Shepard breaks it to the inside, stumbles here, and that's how he was able to get caught. A great return, 52 yards for Darrell Shepard. I think that is the second longest for the season, besides Rhymes' 68-yard touchdown return against Stanford.
Exactly right. We had a flag on the play. Some of that's going to get called back. Anthony Davis was on the tackle, but a clipping penalty against Oklahoma is going to wipe out some of the great return by Derek Shepard. But Oklahoma will still start with great field position as they will start from the Iowa State 44-yard line. 8:12 to go here in the third quarter.
Mike Clopton still in the game at quarterback for Oklahoma. He has played since late in the second quarter. We do not think there's an injury on Danny Bradley, just a matter of giving Clopton some playing time.
Jerome Ledbetter at fullback. Spencer Tillman dots the I. Tillman on the carry up the middle. Gets a couple. Barry Moore and Steve Little, the two best down linemen for Iowa State, there on the tackle for the Cyclones. 8 minutes on the clock and it's running. Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State 35-3.
Well, Little and Moore are doing a lot more here in the second half for Iowa State, as there's the stop inside. Cyclones have stuffed the middle just a little bit. Sooners have been gaining about 2 or 3 yards a pop, whereas in the first half they were picking up in the neighborhood of 8 to 10 yards every time they touched it on the ground.
Second down for Oklahoma and 8 from the Iowa State 42. Clopton to throw. He's got Buster Rhymes. Pretty good catch by Buster Rhymes. Pretty good throw by Mike Clopton. It'll be a first down, a pickup of 11.
11 yards, and if our calculations are correct, that is the 19th catch this season for Buster Rhymes, which would pass Tinker Owens, who caught 18 in 1974. So Rhymes now has caught more passes than any receiver in the last 9 years. 11-yard play. 62 yards on the day for Buster, including a 44-yard grab in the first half.
And Billy McHugh once again on the tackle. They are really working that young lad over today. First and 10 from the Iowa State 31. In the I formation, Sewell's in motion, option right, pitch to Tillman, a block by Ledbetter. Tillman on his feet, inside the 20, and we've got a flag.
I thought I saw a penalty flag over there on the sideline. It might have been a ball marker, Robbie. My apologies, but I thought there for a second we might have had a holding call. It was just a ball mark. Sooners have not been penalized that many times today. 3 for 30 as compared to 15 against Oklahoma State last week.
A vast improvement, I think. Oklahoma now with 19 first downs. Spencer Tillman picked up 8. Take another look at Mike Clopton, who seems to run the option pretty well today. Gets the pitch to Tillman.
Spencer down the sideline. This is where Oklahoma backs scare you to death. They know how to tightrope that boundary and get away just about the time you think they're tackled.
Second and 2 from the 23. In the eye, hand off to Ledbetter up the middle. Gets to the 20-yard line. Inside the 20, it'll be a first down for Oklahoma. Barry Moore on the stop for Iowa State. Spencer Tillman looking for a 100-yard day. He's got 72. Earl Johnson's got 111 yards. Jerome Ledbetter, 37 yards today on the ground. Oklahoma over the 290-yard mark in rushing. It's a first down for the Sooners. Sewell and Rhymes, split receivers. Sewell comes in motion. Tillman up the middle, close to the 15-yard line. Pickup of about 5. Take a look at the Iowa State bench as they look on. Spencer Tillman rushed for 131 yards against Kansas State, shut down the past 2 weeks, but now getting an opportunity to run from the high back position, a position that is better suited for his talents, as Chuck Thomas, the center for Oklahoma, leaves the field. Travis Simpson, freshman from Norman, now the center for Oklahoma. Clopton rolls left, passing for Derek Shepard, who makes the grab. Great catch by Derek Shepard, the freshman from Odessa, Texas, averaging better than 19 yards a catch. He had a great punt return and just makes a fine catch for 9 yards right there.
Well, this is something Oklahoma's receivers were not doing when the season started. They could not go up and make the difficult catches. This time, Shepard has to leave his feet, and he, of course, rose to stardom in the Ohio State game with grabs like that. Good catch for 9 yards by this nifty little player, a member of a trio of Shepherds that have played here, Woody, Darrell, and now Derek Shepard.
And it's first and goal for the Sooners from the 8-yard line. Shepard goes in motion. The pitch to Spencer Tillman gets away from one defender, drops the football. It's still loose. Iowa State's after it, and they've got it. Another fumble by Spencer Tillman, his second of the day. The second turnover for Oklahoma, and the offense is stopped again by themselves. Take another look at it.
Spencer Tillman has lost both fumbles today, this time on second effort only. He's just trying to get away and make the yardage, but from behind, he is hit there by number 23, Kevin Williams, the cornerback. And we have an injured player on the field. Kevin Williams, I believe, is still down for Iowa State, the one who caused that fumble, and it was finally recovered by the Cyclone. So, injured Cyclone on the field. Iowa State will start at the 22-yard line, trailing 35-3.
George Walker recovers the fumble for Oklahoma, for Iowa State, with 5:31 to go in the third quarter. Oklahoma 35, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. Spencer Tillman on the Oklahoma sideline, his second fumble of the day. Kevin Williams caused it. Kevin Williams now coming off the field under his own power, so it would appear he will be all right. George Walker recovered it. Spencer Tillman fumbled last week against Oklahoma State.
October 31st.
He feels worse about it than anybody else in the place. So Iowa State will start from their own 22-yard line, first and 10, 5:31 to go, third quarter. Jason Jacobs in motion. Archer to throw. Over the middle to Jacobs. Gets across the 30, now across the 35.
Same situation again for Iowa State. Jacobs lining up in a slot back or wing back position, and he just runs out into the flat where the zones where Oklahoma is not covering. That's the intermediate zone that Iowa State likes to work. And this time, Jacobs, as he did on the last Iowa State possession, gets big yardage up the middle, runs through a couple of tackles. He's hard to bring down. And the Cyclones have it at the 35-and-a-half-yard line. A
couple of freshman linebackers for the Sooners, Evan Gatewood and Egan Collins. First and 10 for Iowa State from their own 36. The handoff goes to Tommy Davis up the middle. He picks up about four, close to the 40-yard line. Iowa State trailing 35-3. Ricky Bryan on the stop for Oklahoma. Egan Collins also in there. Collins, a 6'2", 222-pound freshman from Miami, Florida. It'll be second and 7 now for Iowa State from their own 39. So a pickup of 3 for Tommy Davis. Archer back to pass. Over the middle. He's got Brett Blaney, one of his tight ends. Iowa State uses about 3 tight ends, 3 different flankers. A pickup of 15 yards for Iowa State as Brett Blaney makes his third reception of the year. His dad played at Iowa State in the mid-50s. Take another look at Archer over the middle.
Just a good pass by David Archer. He threaded 3 Sooner defenders there, and then Blaney did some tough running as he ran past Todd Smith from Norman, who's in the game, and Keith Stanberry.
First and 10 for Iowa State. They go to Davis or Jacobs up the middle. He picks up just a couple. Very tough to run against this Oklahoma defense. They gave up. They have given up just 34 yards on the ground. Oklahoma comes into the game number 1 in the conference, number 10 in the nation, defense against the run, 92 yards.
Looks like the Sooners have their front interior people in there on defense, but they've gone with some reserve linebackers in the backfield. It's spiced up with some second teamers, getting a little playing time here.
Jacobs, the lone setback, second and 8 from the 42. The hand goes to Jacobs across the 40. We've got a flag on the play. Jacobs did a nice piece of running there as he cut back across the green. Got inside the 40, but we'll have to read the flag.
Well, we've got Rick Bryan, I believe, down on the field, and let's isolate on this play and see what happened, because Ricky is slow to get up, and he's being aided off the field. Might have twisted an ankle. Let's watch the play. Jacobs running for some tough yardage, and Bryan trying to get in on the tackle at the end there. Might have had somebody fall on him, but he seems to be favoring that left leg as he goes off the field, and that would be some kind of a loss for the Sooners, but he appears to be okay.
Freshman Roy Owens in the secondary for Oklahoma. Tony Rayburn, a freshman. Todd Smith, a freshman. All working in the secondary for the Oklahoma Sooners, who are operating with a 35-3 lead over Iowa State with 3:32 to go. The penalty is going to be against the Cyclones. A holding call. So instead of being close to a first down, it is now going to be second and 18. The ball is at the Iowa State 46-yard line. 3:31 to go in the third quarter. Next week, the Oklahoma Sooners home against the Kansas Jayhawks. Jacobs, the lone setback for Iowa State. Archer back to pass. Needs 18 yards. Into trouble. Tries to throw the ball away. It's batted around. Whoa, we've got some action down on the field as Bob Slater really hooking it up with Bruce Westermeyer. I'm telling you what, it was like two heavyweights out there in the middle of the ring.
They were playing a little game of elbows. Let's watch David Archer as he goes back to pass, and Evan Gatewood will have the ball hit him in the hands after Danny Wilson makes a good pursuit here. Look at Wilson, has him around the ankles, Casillas in there. Archer throws it, that's a risky pass. Gatewood has it hit him in the hands, and then watch the aftermath. As you'll see, 68, bottom of your screen, 75, take that. Take that.
I'm telling you what. They have thrown both players out of the game. And understandably so. Those two fellas, Bob Slater, a senior defensive tackle for Oklahoma, and Bruce Westermeyer, a sophomore right guard for Iowa State, just stood out there and threw punches at each other. Personal foul, offsetting penalties against both teams. Both players have been ejected from the game. So tempers flare here with 3:07 to go in the third quarter, and Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State 35-3. It may be more out of frustration than anything else, but you can't stand there and throw punches at each other like that. Looked to me like Slater got the better end of that deal. So it'll be a third down play for the Iowa State Cyclones, third and 18. Again, the ball spotted at the 46, offsetting penalties, so they'll just do the play over again. The incomplete pass, third and 18 now. Archer back to pass, under pressure, picked off. Scott Case for the interception. He's got some running room on the far boundary. An excellent block inside the 20. Scott Case is going to score. 68 yards of a touchdown. Tony Rayburn with a great block.
Scott Case showing us a little speed there down the right boundary. He looks like a running back there. A 68-yard touchdown return with the interception. Now watch the reason for the interception. Archer goes back to pass, and he is under pressure, and he releases it on the way down. Look at Tommy Flemings, who causes Archer to hurry the pass. Case makes the interception, and then watch Tony Rayburn, if we can pick him up. Case finds the block, looks for number 35 to give him that clearing shot, and you'll see it coming up here in a minute. A 68-yard return, thanks to number 35 in the red, leading the play. There's the block on Archer, and Scott Case gets into the end zone. Oklahoma 41-3 lead.
A fourth interception of the year for Scott Case, safe at third, touchdown. Scott Case, 68 yards. Lasher with a point after, it's good. 2:51 to go in the third quarter. Oklahoma 42, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. The Sooner Schooner goes off the field. That Sooner Schooner's really had a workout today as Oklahoma runs it up to 42-3, and everybody contributing now as the defense gets into the ball game here. Scott Case with his fourth interception of the year.
Pass was intended for Robbie Miner, number 87, who has had all kinds of problems trying to receive a pass today. But Tony Rayburn, the freshman from Douglas, has really impressed us today. Look at 35. There's the block on David Archer, and you don't think Mr. Archer is going to be sore tomorrow. A great run by Scott Case, and he slides in. Looks like Ricky Henderson there sliding in for a stolen base. 68-yard play. Oklahoma leads it 42-3, and you can see the Cyclones on the bench there. They're a tired bunch of folks trailing 42-3.
That obviously the longest interception return of the year. Rockford had a 21-yard return against Ohio State. Lasher kicks it deep to Hansen. Yeah, the ball bounces. Hansen ends up with it at the 10 and swarm under. Oh, Oklahoma is fired up. Jeff Haight, again on the special teams. Haight has done a good job out there, and he was on the spot there as Iowa State got mixed up a bit. Listen to the crowd of 75,000.
is a football team that has come a long way over the last 2.5 weeks. They've aged about 10 or 15 years with all the distractions they've had. They put it together with that come-from-behind win against Oklahoma State last week, and this has been by far their best performance of 1983, starting at their own 13, Iowa State, trailing 42-3.
Isn't it amazing how that momentum is contagious, Bob? Archer to pass, out of trouble, looking for some place to run. He's across the 20, up to about the 23-yard line.
Pretty good run by David Archer, 10-yard scramble for the Iowa State quarterback, the senior, who went to Snow Junior College, I think, in Utah, and the head coach at Snow Junior College now is Walt Kreiner, Jim Kreiner's brother. So a little bit of family ties there, but David Archer in no mood to talk about the coach's brothers today. He's got to do something about a 39-point deficit, 2:37 to go in the third quarter.
First and 10 for Iowa State from their 23. The draw play to Jason Jacobs across the 35. The tackle made by Tony Raber. 14-yard pickup, and we've got the whistle blows as we have a flag on the far side of the field.
Jason Jacobs reminds me a lot of Dwayne Crutchfield, the former Iowa State star who's playing for the Jets. He is so powerful, weighs 230, but looks like it's even more from up here. And I think we have a personal foul penalty against Oklahoma following the play. That's the preliminary indication. Referees will mark off 15 more, so that turns into a big, big play for Iowa State. Gets them into Sooner territory at the 48-yard line.
Jason Jacobs averaging better than 4 yards a carry coming into today's ball game. Personal foul against Oklahoma. So that spots the ball, as Bob Berry Jr. said, at the Oklahoma 48-yard line. First and 10 for the Cyclones. Take a look at the penalties on the day. First down for Iowa State. Split backs. The handoff goes to Tommy Davis up the middle. No place to run. Tackle is made by Tommy Flemons and Danny Wilson. Take another look as Archer hands to little Tommy Davis. Wilson gets to him first.
65 there for Iowa State. Kevin Eggleston, the biggest player in the Big 8 Conference, 6 feet 8, 292 pounds. He reported at 330 pounds before spring football started.
Only a sophomore, might still grow some more. Second and 9 from the 47. Archer to throw. He's got Danny Gant at the 40-yard line. It'll be short of a first down. Pickup of 7 for Danny Gant, the sophomore from Cerritos, California. Roy Owens and Egan Collins on the stop for Oklahoma.
The Iowa State coaches like Danny Gant's size, I think, more than anything. He's 6 feet four, almost 6'5", and weighs in at close to 200 pounds. He's caught 3 passes for 24 yards today. He's built a lot like Buster Rhymes, who is also 6'4", but a little heavier at about 215, and he's got some real good speed.
Steve Bryan and Jeff Tupper in the ballgame now as Tommy Flemons runs off the field late. Oklahoma had 12 men on the field. I don't see any flags anywhere, so obviously nobody was watching Tommy Flemons. Little confusion on the Oklahoma defense. Iowa State gets a first down inside the Oklahoma 35-yard line. Now we'll see if the Oklahoma defense can get straightened out, using a lot of people here in the second half. Steve Bryan, Jeff Tupper. Iowa State comes to the line, first and 10 from the Oklahoma 34. Handoff goes to Tommy Davis. Picks up a couple of yards. Todd Smith had a shot at him. Knocked him off his feet a bit. Flemons goes off.
I think these two teams are getting a little bit irritated with each other. As we saw a moment ago, Jeff Wadka and Keith Stanbury, a few words. Of course, Bob Slater was booted out of the ballgame moments ago along the Iowa State line. A little frustration down there.
Archer rolls to the right, looking for somebody to throw it to. He's under trouble, in trouble, and down he goes. Evan Gatewood on the tackle for Oklahoma, a loss of 8. Oklahoma's going to have to use those freshman linebackers next year as Jackie Shipp and Thomas Benson, the two starters, are both seniors. And there's the gun to end the third quarter. At the end of three quarters, Oklahoma 42, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. We've got 15 minutes of football left. The Oklahoma Sooners out in front of Iowa State 42-3, the biggest offensive output of the year point-wise for Oklahoma. It is a third down and 15 situation for Iowa State from the 39, and down goes Archer again. Danny Wilson on the sack.
And Danny Wilson says, that's right, I'm the one that made that play, and he sure did all by himself as Wilson came in there and powered past Mike Schindelar, the Iowa State offensive lineman. Watch the play. Look at 98, bottom of your screen. 60, Schindelar trying to hold, tackle, and do everything else. And it's the fourth sack of the day for Oklahoma as a team. And Danny Wilson gets the sack. 255 pounds, built on a pretty short but stocky six-foot frame.
26th sack of the year for the Oklahoma Sooners. Danny Wilson, a six-foot, 255-pound senior from Sherman, Texas.
21 first downs for the Sooners to 16 for Iowa State after three quarters. 297 yards rushing for Oklahoma to just 60 for Iowa State. Passing yardage, not really that much of a concern for the Sooners. Iowa State, 193, that's way below their average. Total offense, over 400 yards for Oklahoma. Turnovers are the same. And believe it or not, Iowa State's run five more plays than Oklahoma, but they trail 42-3.
14:23 to go in the ball game. Oklahoma 42, Iowa State 3. Iowa State in a punting situation. Kelly Gertberg back at about his own 40-yard line. He'll hit it at about the 35. Back deep for Oklahoma, Scott Case. Gertberg averaging almost 35 yards a kick today. Had a 46-yard punt, his only time he has kicked this half. The punt's away. Sonny Brown calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 20-yard line. So Oklahoma will start first and 10 after the 24-yard kick.
Well, I sure have been impressed with Sonny Brown, by the way, who got the start today because Jim Rockford is out with an injury. Scott Case moved over to a cornerback, and Brown has been in there at free safety. He's had a great game. A freshman from Alice, Texas, Sonny Brown. Good game. The crowd getting into this ball game, starting here in the fourth quarter. Mike Clopton still at quarterback.
Oklahoma's made some changes in the offensive line. We'll give them to you right after this play. Clopton with a pitch to Earl Johnson, who is hit after a pickup of about two. Brent Burks at left tackle. Scott Leggett, Travis Simpson, Sidney Dodd, David Dillingham, Darren Berryhill at tight end for Oklahoma, the men up front. Take another look at Earl Johnson, who picks up just a yard.
On the day now, Johnson has 11 carries for 112 yards. Of course, he had a 50-yard run and a 30-yard run in the first quarter alone.
Steve Little for Iowa State being helped off the field. So now we'll try and get a look at that offensive line again for you. Travis Simpson is the center. Pickett and Leggett at the guards. Burks at the tackle. A bad pitch to Earl Johnson. He goes and gets it. Falls on it. The ball is still loose. And Iowa State's going to come up with it if they didn't whistle it dead. And they didn't. And Iowa State has come up with a third Oklahoma turnover.
All three, but they're having a big discussion down there, Robbie. The officials, I think Oklahoma was hoping they would call it the ball down after Earl Johnson dove the first time, but he was not. It was a fumble, and we'll watch the play again and show you what happened. This could have been Clopton's worst pitch of the day, obviously. He threw it out there a little hard and a little too far in front of Earl Johnson, but it was a catchable pitch. Johnson tried to dive on it here, which is the smart thing to do, but he couldn't corral it. George Walker tried to get it. He couldn't. Iowa State now deep in Oklahoma territory. Their deepest penetration of the day by far is Coach Switzer over there next to Danny Bradley. Iowa State first and 10 at the Sooner 11-yard line.
Lester Williams on the recovery for Iowa State. The Tasmanian Devil picks up the third turnover for Oklahoma today, and Iowa State needs to go just 11 yards to get on the board. First and 10 from the 11. Archer to throw. Tries to hit Robbie Miner, who tried to make a one-handed catch. No. Make that Jeff Watka. Tried to make the one-handed catch and couldn't hold on.
Watch it again. Good defense by Keith Stanberry again. Sooner defensive backs are coming up tight on these Iowa State receivers. Watka could have grabbed that football, but Stanberry was there to make sure he didn't catch on. On the day now, and officially, Archer, 19 of 34 for about 193 yards.
Watka is out. Jacobs and Davis are the backs. Robbie Miner in motion to the far side of the field. Archer rolls left. Under pressure, he's got Tommy Davis overthrowing. Under pressure by Kevin Murphy.
Well, no doubt Tommy Davis was wide open, but Archer was having all kinds of problems fighting off Kevin Murphy and many others. Let's watch the play again. Great job by our camera people. Look at Archer now. He's got to go left, and then he says, oh, there's nothing going on there, and here comes Kevin Murphy. Just about grabs David Archer before he throws it, and Davis, had he have been about 6'3 or 4, might have had that football, but he's a short guy at about 5'8 or 9 and couldn't come up with it.
Well, it's kind of tough to throw that football the way you'd like to when you've got 6'2, 225 hanging all over you, right? It's third and 11 for Iowa State from the Sooner 11-yard line, and now Archer doesn't like what he sees. He calls timeout. There's timeout on the field. 13-7 to go. 13-07 to go in the ball game. Oklahoma 42, Iowa State 3. This is Oklahoma football. Robbie Robertson along with Bob Berry Jr. 13-07 to go in the ball game. Oklahoma out in front of Iowa State 42-3. It's not a matter of Oklahoma winning the football game. It's a matter of by how much. And just in the first half, as Oklahoma scored on five of their six possessions, they've had some trouble here in the second half. They missed a 43-yard field goal attempt on their first possession, and they have fumbled the ball away on their last two possessions, although sandwiched in between there was a 68-yard interception return for a touchdown by Scott Case.
Pretty big story there on third down conversions. Oklahoma 7-9, Iowa State 8-15, and the Sooners have even completed converted on 1-of-1 fourth down conversion. So that's why they're in the lead. David Archer is only one out of his last five after that red hot start. Remember, in the first quarter on that initial drive by the Cyclones, Archer completed four of his first five passes.
Casillas, Tupper, Clemens, and Wilson, the down linemen for Oklahoma. Jason Jacobs in motion, the handoff to Davis right up the middle, inside the five, down to about the two. Tommy Davis with some good hard running for Iowa State as that offensive line opened up a pretty good hole for Tommy Davis. Scott Case and Tony Rayburn on the stop.
Good trap block there by Ben Reimer, 72. He's the veteran of this line, and he knocked Tony Rayburn back a few yards. Davis, normally the one that runs away from defenders, he just put his head down and buried it inside. Cyclones now at the 2-yard line, but they still got a fourth down situation.
Rayburn's out. John Truitt in at a defensive end spot. Fourth and two. Archer rolls, looking to throw. Now he throws it into the end zone. Touchdown, Iowa State, as Jeff Watka makes his second touchdown reception of the year. I thought Archer was going to try and run that in himself, and then he held up and threw the ball to the back of the end zone where he found Jeff Watka.
I think that's why Iowa State was able to complete the pass, because the pursuit came up when David Archer made that move right there, and he just pulled up like the wise veteran he is and hit Watka. Scott Case right there, but from 2 yards out, not too tough to get it in from that position. Watka had the advantage, and Iowa State, their first touchdown of the day, they trail 42-9.
And Iowa State's going to go for two. Don't blame them, 42-9. Archer rolls right. Going to throw, and Jacobs makes the catch and steps in the end zone. The two-point conversion is good. Keith Stanberry on the coverage, but the two-point play is good.
Pretty good athletic move. Watch Jacobs now. He has to catch this ball over his shoulder and then realize where he is and get that foot on the inbounds. Here it is right here, and he just puts that one foot in right there and gets the two-point conversion. So we have 12:25 to go in the game. Oklahoma leads Iowa State 42-11. This is Oklahoma football.
Bob Berry Jr. along with Robbie Robertson. This is Iowa State's two-point conversion following their only touchdown of the day, 12 and a half minutes away from the end of this game. Archer to Jacobs. Now the play is made by Jacobs. First, the over-the-shoulder grab with tough coverage, and then the 1 foot just inside the flag there. And that's 2 points, 42 to 11.
So Iowa State just has to go 11 yards to get points on the board. 12:25 to go. Oklahoma out in front 42 to 11. Back rote, kicking deep. Ball bounces around. Ends up in the hands of Alvin Ross, who gets across the 25 and the 30 before he is brought down. So Oklahoma will start their fourth possession of the second half. Tackle was made by Scott Williams, special team player for Iowa State. Oklahoma will start this drive from their own 31-yard line.
So after the Sooner fumble, their drive for Iowa State was pretty short, 11 yards and just four plays. Took a minute 51 off the clock. The touchdown play, a short pass, 2 yards. David Archer to Jeff Wodka. Oklahoma leads at 42 to 11.
Clopton, the quarterback. The hand goes to Earl Johnson up the middle. He gets close to the 35-yard line. Alvin Ross is the fullback. Oklahoma just let the clock run. 12:07 to go. They lead 42 to 11. This is an opportunity for Oklahoma to play a lot of players, and it's a good move because they'll need them as they get farther into the Big 8 conference schedule in hopes that they end up undefeated as they play the Nebraska Cornhuskers the final game of the year. Clopton hands to Ross up the middle, close to the 40, short of the first down. Tackle made by Little and Gilliard.
Things don't get any easier for Iowa State following this game as we watch the replay of Alvin Ross. Once again, looking for that cutback move initially, as he's done several times today. The Cyclones will go from Norman to hosting Missouri next week. The Tigers, an improved team. And then Iowa State has to go to Nebraska, which is no fun at all. And so Iowa State coming in here at 3-3, 2-0 in the Big 8. If they lose today, they could easily lose to Missouri and Nebraska. Of course, it could be a 2-3 Big 8 season in a hurry.
Mitch Bryan in at tight end. Spencer Tillman at the top of the eye. Sewell in motion. Ross the fullback. The hand goes to Tillman off the left side. He is across the 42. He's got the first down. Oklahoma with a lot of the second team players in there in that offensive line. Jeff Pickett, a freshman, as you watch Spencer Tillman. LaDorfia Stripling, a freshman. David Dillingham, the junior at right tackle. Darren Berryhill at tight end. Travis Simpson, the freshman center. First down for Oklahoma. Clopton to throw, throws it over the head and behind Steve Sewell.
More or less a timing pattern on that play, and Sewell once again looked like turned to the inside and the ball went to the outside. Clopton has had a couple of problems with that, but on the other hand, he threw a 44-yard strike to Buster Rhymes in the first half and hit Rhymes on another 17 or 18-yarder deep in Iowa State territory in the third quarter. Mike Clopton has gone all the way here in the second half at quarterback for Oklahoma, and this is invaluable experience for him as they head down the stretch in this Big 8 race.
Second and 10 for the Sooners from their own 43. Clopton to throw, looking for Rhymes. A little bit short, and Rhymes takes a vicious hit, and the flag goes down. Well, I'll tell you what, Buster Rhymes was really smacked by Sam Clear.
Well, Sam did that. He cleared the way for a penalty of 15 yards. Watch the pop here. Pretty flagrant, especially right in front of the home team bench. You don't want to do that.
Yeah, when you're over in front of strangers, you don't want to do that. Sam Clear is a 6'1", 201-pound senior from Chicago, Illinois. He was the number two strong safety this year until they made some changes in that secondary for Iowa State. Alvin Baker came over from cornerback to the starting strong safety. Billy McHugh moved to the number two strong safety, and that kind of dropped Sam Clear off the depth chart. He is used at times in a nickel defense. As you take a look at the penalty against Iowa State, it's going to be a personal foul against Sam Clear. So Oklahoma gets another first down out of the situation. First and 10 from the Iowa State 42. 10:38 to go, 10:39 to go in the ball game. Oklahoma leading 42 to 11. The handoff is to Spencer Tillman, left side. Can't find any running room. He'll be stopped for no gain by Barry Moore.
I've been pretty impressed with Barry Moore and Steve Little here in the second half. two gamers that haven't quit at all. Now look at 91 in white, LaDorfius Stripling on the block there, but Moore pops off of it there and stops Spencer Tillman for short yardage. Moore and Little, two players that were not expected to do a whole lot for Iowa State as far as individual stardom, but they've hung in there all season long and given the Cyclones some adequate play on the defensive side.
Give Tillman a pickup of one, second and nine from the 41. A hand to Tillman again. Big hole at the 30. Cuts back to the near boundary. Looking for a block from Ryan. 15, 10, 5, out of bounds. Spencer Tillman at the 3-yard line. And we've got that dirty laundry on the field again. Another flag on the play.
Well, that's how quick Oklahoma can hit you, especially Tillman, the way he runs, and he got a great block from Buster Rhymes, but all the red jerseys are walking back the other way.
And 75,000 are booing that call, but it's going to be a holding call as you take a look at Jim Kreiner, the Iowa State head coach. You mentioned Iowa State will be playing the Missouri Tigers next week. Iowa State, in the past 4 years, they have a record of 2-12 in the month of November, and they have currently lost six in a row in November, and it could be that way again this year as you take a look at Spencer Tillman, who makes a great cutback right there.
The cutback at about the 30-yard line was the key, and then watch Buster Rhymes, who used to play a wishbone halfback in his first years here. He makes a good block on Billy McHugh. Spencer can't quite get into the end zone, but it didn't matter because of the holding call. The fourth holding penalty of the day, fifth overall penalty against the Sooners, and I guess the ball will be marked at about the 21-yard line.
Spencer Tillman nears the 100-yard mark. He now has 92 yards on 21 carries. And to finish the thought about Iowa State in the month of November, they have Nebraska and Kansas State on the road in November this year, and then they close the season at home against Oklahoma State. So they might not have any success in November this year either. First and 10 for the Sooners from the 21-yard line. Sewell in motion. Clopton rolls left, and he's in trouble down. Outside the 30-yard line as the Tasmanian Devil Lester Williams got in there and sacked Mike Clopton.
9-yard loss for Iowa State on that play. They sent everybody. It was a blitzing situation. Clopton had no chance because he was rushed from the blind side. You see Williams in there along with George Walker, one of the defensive backs who came in. 9 yards back, so the Sooners have gone backwards following the great run by Tillman. They're now at the 30, and it's second down and 19 situation.
See if Clopton will put the ball in the air. Buster Rhymes and Derek Shepard go wide left. Ross the fullback, Spencer Tillman the tailback. The handoff goes to Spencer Tillman. He's got room, a good move at the 25, the 20, the 15, 10, down, close to the 5-yard line, mark it at the 6. Oh, he is so shifty, Spencer Tillman. That puts him over the 100-yard mark for the second time this year.
And I wonder how many games or how long it's been since Oklahoma has had two backs in the same game with over 100 yards. I bet it's been a while, and they have two today. Here is Spencer Tillman's run around the right side as he toys with the defensive backs a little bit before getting down inside the 10-yard line at about the 6, so they're right back where they were three plays ago.
Finally run out of bounds by Dwayne Gilliard. Finally brought down by Dwayne Gilliard. First and goal from the 6, Oklahoma. Shepard in motion. The handoff to Tillman, right side. Picks up a couple inside the 5. Well, that's exactly what Barry Switzer wanted out of that tailback spot. And Earl Johnson and Spencer Tillman, as you take another look at Tillman with the run, they both said that they don't mind sharing the duties at all because one tailback cannot run the ball 30 or 40 times and be as fresh as he needs to be. And right now, Spencer Tillman with 119 yards, Earl Johnson with 116 yards on 35 carries between them. Second down and goal from the 3. Tillman dives a little bit short. He did that dive for his first touchdown of the day, but he didn't have quite enough oomph on that particular dive and comes up a little bit short.
Let's watch it again from down low where we can really appreciate the vertical dive, or horizontal dive in this case. Look at Spencer up and over everybody, but right into the waiting arms of Dwayne Gilliard. Chris Washington was there, and the Sooners are a little short inside the 1, about a foot to go.
7:27 on the clock, third and goal from the 1. Clopton tries to get it in there. Touchdown, Mark Clopton in Oklahoma. So Oklahoma rings up the scoreboard again. 7:22 to go as Mike Clopton gets in the scoring column. Just a one-yard plunge by Mike Clopton, and we're heading for our record book now to see when's the last time Oklahoma has scored this many points as Tim Lasher comes on to try the point after, as you see Clopton take it in. Lasher's been a busy boy today, missed a field goal, but he has been good on all the point afters. With 7:22 to go in the ball game, Oklahoma 49, Iowa State 11. This is Oklahoma football.
You may not have been expecting it, but here it is. An American
here to put the ball in the air. The last time Oklahoma scored this many points was 2 years ago against Colorado. Tim Lasher ready to tee it up and boots it through the end zone. No return for Richard Hansen on that one. So Iowa State will start from their own 20-yard line with 7:22 to go, and Oklahoma leads 49-11.
And Iowa State's David Archer, even though it's been a losing cause, 49-11 here with 7:22 to go in the game. Archer has set an Iowa State career record today for most completions in a career. He has 20 in today's game. His career mark now 261, which breaks the old mark of 252 set by Tim Van Gelder of Iowa State years ago.
Well, Iowa State is running their second team offensive line, and they have second string quarterback Alan Hood in there, a 6'1 sophomore from St. Louis, who rolls right looking for someplace to go, and he runs the ball across the 25 to about the 27-yard line. Alan Hood played in the first game of the year, and he hasn't seen any action since, a pickup of 7.
Well, you notice the difference right off between Archer and Hood in that appears Mr. Hood's a pretty good runner as he spun to the outside there. Did a little 180 turn to get away from Tommy Flemons and others and picked up 7 yards. So Iowa State at about their own 27-yard line. Plenty of yardage to go, trailing 49-11.
It'll be 2nd and 3 for Iowa State from their own 27-yard line. Danny Gant comes in motion near side. The handoff goes to Richard Hansen, who gets close to the 30-yard line and across the 30, and a flag goes down. Might have a face mask or an illegal hit there on Percy Hines, a defensive back for Oklahoma.
That's pretty much a judgment call. Looked like Hines was in motion as far as making his tackle as we see it again, and he will be called probably for a personal foul. Obviously, they're marking off 15 yards. Let's watch it. Hansen is stumbling, trying to go down, and Hines is just eager in his first game in a while to make the tackle, and there's the spear right there, personal foul.
We get an opportunity to learn a few things every single week, and that's the first time we've become familiar with Percy Hines, a 5'10", 180-pound freshman from Lubbock, Texas. First down for Iowa State at their own 46-yard line. 6:26 to go on the clock, and it's running. Alan Hood, the quarterback for Iowa State. Hansen and Kirk Thomas are the running backs. The pitch goes to Hansen around the right side, and he will go nowhere. Jeff Tupper on the tackle, along with Evan Gatewood for Oklahoma. Tupper has seen some playing time this year. 6'5", 255-pound sophomore from Joplin, Missouri. Alan Hood in that first ball game of the year, as far as Hood's passing statistics are concerned, he was 1 of 3 for 65 yards in the Iowa game, and it was a 65-yard touchdown pass to Mike Posey. It's a 2nd and 9 situation for Iowa State now from their own 46-yard line. Fumble, ball goes loose, Hood picks it up, swarmed under at his 41-yard line. The pitch went to Richard Hansen, who fumbled it away, but Iowa State got a good bounce.
Let's watch it again and see who made the hit right on the football. Tony Casillas, number 92. Let's watch it with the helmet. There you go. Knocks it out of Richard Hansen's hands. Alan Hood, the fortunate one standing back there, but he wasn't really motivated to run at that time. And the linebackers, Gatewood and Collins, make the tackle.
Looked like a shortstop the way he picked that thing up.
I would have booted it on that play.
Third and 15 from the Iowa State 41. 5 minutes to go. Now we're under 5 minutes. Oklahoma leads 49-11. Gant comes in motion near side. The pitch goes to Hansen. Up across the 45-yard line. Uh-oh, here comes it in. The punting team for Iowa State. Fourth down situation, and Kelly Goodburn into punt formation. Fourth and 11 for Iowa State. Snap is back. Goodburn hits it away. Sonny Brown calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 30-yard line. So a 25-yard punt for Kelly Goodburn. Brown on the fair catch, and Oklahoma goes back on offense at their own 30-yard line with 4:18 to go.
And the Sooners really have some different faces in there now. I can see Butch Byfield in the game. And Mike Clopton still in there at quarterback. Mitch Bryan is in the game. Jerome Ledbetter. So we'll see all kinds of new faces here with 4:18 to go.
Well, it gives you an opportunity to do that when you lead 49-11. Coach Switzer getting an opportunity to play a lot of people. Ledbetter is the fullback, and he takes the handoff, gets across the 30, maybe up to the 31, for a pickup of just a couple. Mitch Bryan, Bill Earthman in at tight end. Coach Switzer with a smile on his face. Hasn't had many of those this year, even with a record of 4-2. Perhaps he feels a little bit better about that offense.
He's bouncing around there having a good time with Mike Jones and Danny Bradley and Fred Christian, the linesman there wearing the striped shirt. Been a good day for Oklahoma's offense, and that was the big concern coming in. They've been extremely consistent, and officially 406 yards total offense right now.
Second and 9 from the 31. The handoff. As soon as we find the player's name and number, we'll give it to you. Running in some people there that we are not familiar with that are not on the chart.
Looks like Darrell or Weddington to me, if I'm not mistaken.
That's exactly who it is.
And his brother, the former defensive end tight end that was a good ball player for Oklahoma. Mike Weddington played the New Jersey Generals briefly last year in the SFL.
3:05 to go in the ball game. It is now 3rd and 6 from the 34. Darrell Weddington is the tailback. Ledbetter, the fullback. The handoff to Darrell Weddington across the 35, up close to the 40, short of the first down. Darrell Weddington, 5'10", 198-pound senior from Temple, Texas. So Iowa State has held the Sooners, and Darren Ataya will be back in punt formation. I don't believe Ataya has had the punt today.
Correct again, Kemosabe. This is number 1. Now watch old Darrell Weddington go left side here.
Billy McHugh is deep for Iowa State. 2:17 left to play. Ataya kicks the ball. Low, returnable by McHugh. Takes it across the 30, up to the 35, and then swarmed under. Iowa State goes back on offense with 2:08 to go in the ballgame.
36-yard punt by Darren Ataya, 9-yard return as we look at a very frustrated Jim Kreiner, probably ready just to get back to Ames and try and regroup before the Tigers come to Ames. Here's Billy McHugh on the return. I think the Bryan brothers are involved here. There's Mitch, number 97, and Steve, number 86, all in there trying to make the tackle on Billy McHugh.
Well, Jim Kreiner said that this would be the test of his ball club to see if he could come play with the big kids. It's not turned out particularly well as Alan Hood, again, the quarterback. Hood rolls, looks to throw. He's got his receiver out of bounds as Roy Owens makes the tackle. Danny Gant on the reception, a 13-yard pickup for Iowa State. It'll be a first down. Gant got out of bounds, stopped the clock with 2:03 to go. The ball's marked at the 47-yard line. First and 10 for the Cyclones from their own 47. Allen Watson now at running back for Iowa State. Along with Kirk Thomas. Hood throws over the middle. Almost picked off by Roy Owens. Had an opportunity. So everybody gets to play today for both sides. Jim Kreiner has gone to his second line, offensive line, as you see Alan Hood under pressure from Tommy Flemons. Pass was intended for Mike Posey. Hood brings the Cyclones to the line of scrimmage again, second and 10 from their own 47. Handoff goes to Watson, who picks up just a couple of yards up the middle. Alan Watson has no rushing statistics for Iowa State. The whole ball club didn't really have any rushing statistics. 434 yards coming into today's game.
Watson, pretty good back coming into the season. I remember Jim Kreiner mentioned him on the Skyriders tour as a possible replacement for Tommy Davis. They were battling neck and neck in the spring. In fact, Watson was leading rusher in the spring game, but Davis beat him out before the first game, and he's been there most of the season.
Third and 8 now for the Cyclones from the, call it the Iowa State 49, over the middle, in and out of the hands of Kirk Thomas. So it'll be a fourth down situation for Iowa State. Many of the 75,000 faithful are heading for the local watering hole. Kelly Goodburn comes on to punt for Iowa State. Sooners are going to get the ball back with 1:13 to go in the ball game. Back deep for Oklahoma is Sonny Brown. Goodburn boots it away off the side of his foot, bounces at the 30, takes an Iowa State bounce inside the 15, where it now it rolls inside the 10 and out of bounds. At about the 8-yard line, 42-yard punt for Goodburn. As you make it to the stadium, with 1 minute and 1 seconds to go in the ball game, Oklahoma 49, Iowa State 11. This is Oklahoma football. There you see 61 ticks left on the clock. Oklahoma on their way to their fifth victory of the year, but more importantly, they will be 3-0 in conference play as they will be home again next week to take on the Kansas Jayhawks. Fisher at tailback now for Oklahoma. Fisher with the ball over the 15, up close to the 20-yard line. Sam Clear on the tackle.
This is like a Texas A&M game or something. The 12th man on the field.
Yeah.
Oklahoma running players in there that we have to admit we don't know who they are. And plus, there's no name on the jersey, no numerical listing for them on the program. So,
well, I've got him on the suit-up list, but he's not in the press guide and he's not on the flip card, so we will call him Mr. Fisher. That hand up through the middle to Jerome Ledbetter, the tackle made by Brett Lawrence. 14 seconds left on the clock. It's running down to 10. The Sooner fans will count it down. This one goes in the record book, and Coach Switzer has to be a much happier man with his offense, and now they have stopped the clock with 5 seconds left. The Oklahoma players were headed toward the locker room. The Iowa State players were headed toward the locker room. But I think we've got an injury on the field. Jerome Ledbetter, the man down for Oklahoma.
Well, that's a shame. Let's try and see what happened, because Jerome Ledbetter has just come off an injury. And he was getting his first real playing time of the year today. He just got stacked up there in the middle pretty hard. But I can't really tell what happened. He might have fallen on the football. Hopefully that's all it is. But Jerome Ledbetter has been fighting injury much of his career, and it looks like he was just winded a bit and should be okay. 5 seconds to go in the game. Oklahoma will improve their Big 8 mark to 3-0, their overall record to 5-2. And it could have been worse. Remember when it was 3-2 2 weeks ago, and they come on and put a great game together with 466 yards.
And there's the gun. The Oklahoma Sooners have beaten the Iowa State Cyclones 49-11. I want to take an opportunity here to thank our spotters, Jeff and Michelle Keener, and our